Well, following a 5-1 loss last night, the Carolina Thunderbirds are going to try to end up snapping a streak here this evening. Carolina suffering their worst loss of the season last night by 4 goals, and now they're looking for a response here this evening live from Biloxi, Mississippi. It's the 4th and final game of this 4-game stretch between the Carolina Thunderbirds and the Mississippi Seawolves, and it's coming up here in just a little bit. Welcome inside the Mississippi Coast Coliseum for the first time this evening. Brendan Riley with you here on Thunderbirds TV and on WTOB. And last night didn't go Carolina's way, and a big reason why was because of the netminder Blake Wyrick last night for the Mississippi Seawolves. Saved 46 out of 47 shots in the 5-1 victory for the home side, Mississippi, who improved to 16-15-1 on the year. Now up to 45 points here this season. Carolina dropping to 21-7-1. Here in 2023-2024 with 58 points, currently sitting in second in the Continental Division of the FPHL. But for Carolina right now, it's not necessarily what's going on with the other side. It's trying to figure things out with themselves right now. It's been a lot of turnover ever since December 23rd. We'll get into some of the statistics as the night gets going here from Biloxi, but it hasn't been the same. And Steve Harrison, he's had to try to figure things out on the fly here over the past few weeks with guys departing over the past few weeks, ever since Christmas. And it's been a much different looking Thunderbirds team, and as a result of that, since December 23rd, Carolina is 5-4-1 after they started the season out at 16-3-0, the second best start in franchise history. And now for Carolina, they're still getting the goal scoring, but now it's the back end that's going to have to try to be able to find something here. Carolina in a stretch right now where they've allowed 4-plus goals in 5 out of their last 6 games. The only other one was last Saturday against this Mississippi Seawolves team in a 4-2 victory for Carolina back at home at the Annex. So Carolina now, here on the second night of this series, they have the weekend off coming up before they get ready for Danbury next weekend and the bus ride home after tonight, but they can go out there and leave it all on the ice here this evening as Carolina and Mississippi get set to battle for the 4th time here this season. Carolina last night, the 5-1 loss, and the largest loss here this season by margin. There was an empty netter at the end, that was the difference, but last night, it really started in the first period. Carolina outshot Mississippi across the first 20 minutes, 16-8, but it was Mississippi who held a 1-0 lead after the first 20 minutes. Yanni Liarakos got a deflection in front on a shot from Matt Stoyet on the shorthand. That ended up making it 1-0 in favor of Mississippi. The two sides would go to the second in a 1-0 game with Carolina having many, many chances across that first 20. But Blake Wyrick, he was making save after save. And in the second, it was Philip Wong with assists from Jackson Bong and Lucas Helen, making it a 2-0 game. Carolina once again outshooting Mississippi 13-10 in that second. But then on the power play, Matt Stoyet, he made it 3-0 for John Petita. He got his third goal in his last 3 games. He's had a goal in every game here against Mississippi. He's also got 6 goals in each of his last 5 outings here this season. James Farmer and Joe Kennedy insist that made it 3-1. Yanni Liarakos, though, just 2 minutes later, ended up rebuilding the lead to 3. And from there, Mississippi, they started to coast from there on out as Blake Wyrick, he was terrific. He got the second star last night, saving 46 out of 47 shots. Carolina, they had 47 shots last night. They had a lot of opportunities, but Wyrick, he was really the difference maker. Yanni Liarakos, he was named the first star of the evening, with 2 goals and an assist, with Philip Wong as well being named the third star with a goal and 2 assists. So Carolina right now, they are going to have to try to figure out a way to put the puck in the back of the net. No one was discouraged, though. Going on the bus back to the hotel last night, even this morning at breakfast and at lunch and on the way to the rink, no one on this Thunderbirds team was discouraged. They were ready to go. The message from Steve Harrison last night was, get ready, we got to go to war again tomorrow. And Carolina's looking for more of that coming up here this evening. But we got a lot to get to here on Thunderbirds pregame. No Coach Harrison tonight. So we won't hear from the head coach directly. I did chat with him earlier today. I can give you some more of his comments as the night progresses here. But no Coach Harrison here on Thunderbirds pregame here this evening. But we will take a look at the highlights from last night. We'll take a trip around the rest of the FPHL and also start to break down both sides heading into this matchup here this evening. Game number 30 here this season for Carolina. It finishes off the 4th straight here against the Mississippi Seawolves where these two sides see each other in the middle of February. Thunderbirds pregame continues on the other side of this timeout. Carolina and Mississippi. Game 4 coming up here just past the top of the hour. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
For over 85 years, Mustin and Crutchfield has been more than just a local market. We've been a proud part of North Carolina's heritage. When our founders started in 1938, they sourced meats from local farmers and groceries from small companies. Finding a way to stay competitive in this market has been a challenge through the years. Luckily, there are a lot of entrepreneurs, and now we have close to 50 local vendors that we feature. We're proud to partner with the Carolina Thunderbirds as a local sponsor, celebrating community values both on and off the ice. Mustin and Crutchfield, your hometown local grocer.
Here at ComTech, we think it shouldn't cost a fortune to have peace of mind. That's why we bring you the latest in smart home protection and home monitoring at prices you can afford. Already paying for home monitoring? We can beat it. Give us a call today or visit us at ctpower.com. That's ctpower.com. ComTech, your one stop for security, fire, cameras, and more.
Hey there, Triad Thunderbirds fans. Introducing Tee It Up Indoors, your ultimate golfing destination in Greensboro. With our cutting-edge golf simulators, you can tee off on world-class courses, no matter the weather. We're not just a golf facility. We're your partner in having a fantastic time. From golf lessons to corporate events, we've got it all covered. Plus, we even host birthday parties. Tee It Up Indoors, where golf meets excitement. Contact us today and swing into action.
Get ready, Winston-Salem. Jennifer Sapp, your trusted realtor and broker since 1997, puts the real in realtor, and she's proud to be a sponsor of your Carolina Thunderbirds. As a top producer and your go-to realtor for all your real estate needs, Jennifer Sapp is ready to help you score your dream home goal. Call Jennifer at 336-782-3148 or visit her at jennifersapp.allenton.com.
We're back here in Biloxi. We're getting ready for Carolina and Mississippi for the fourth straight time. Mississippi currently leading the season series 2-1. Carolina, though, 1-1-1 here this season against the Seawolves after last Friday, the shootout loss, the 4-2 victory on Saturday last night. Of course, the 5-1 loss, and it's time to take a look at the action from last night. Mississippi, they ended up being able to come away with the 5-1 victory despite Carolina having a lot of opportunities. It's time to take a look at how it looked and sounded here on Thunderbirds TV and on WTOB. Face off to the left of Cody Karpinski. It's won by Mississippi from the point. A quick shot, and they score. Yanni Liorako, center deflection in front from the shot from the point by Matt Stoya. It's a shorthanded goal here with 17:15 left to go in the first period, and Mississippi takes an early 1-0 lead. Alley tries to throw it in. Instead, it goes right into the skates up the near side. Too much on that pass for Jackson Bond. Clay Keeley trying to fend him off. Gets run into, but it still wins the positioning battle. The puck bounces free in front of shot, and they score. Philip Wong able to control the bouncing puck and settle it down right in the slot as he gets his 11th on the season. And it comes with 11:47 left to go here in the second. Mississippi takes a 2-0 lead. The penalty kill as of late has been streaky, now down to 74% here this year, which is 10th in the league. Here's Stoya, top of the slot, a shot, and he scores. Matt Stoya gets his second of the night. He had a shorty bag in the first. This time it comes on the power play with 6:19 left to go here in the second period. Mississippi has taken a 3-0 lead. James Farmer goes cross ice. Kennedy, he waits. Right back to Farmer. Here at 33. Oh, shot, and they score. Carolina on the 26th shot here tonight, finally find the back of the net, and it's John Batita getting his third goal this season here against Mississippi. It comes on the power play, and Carolina, they're able to cut into this lead. They make it 3-1 with 4:24 left to go here in the second period. Throws it in for Liorakos. He has to settle down a bouncing puck. Pastuca trying to clear. Stoya keeps it in. Liarakos goes cross ice. Sam Turner, top of the slot, leaves Liarakos a one-timer, and he scores. Yanni Liarakos on the power play with 2:48 left to go here in the second period. Builds the lead back to 3 for the Seawolves. It's now 4-1. Helen shoves him into the boards. Back out, Liarakos takes a huge hit from Clay Keeley. Comes up to Bondo, the hands up, the backhand, and they score. And now after the play, Schnapp. Furious. As Helen had words, it looked like Clay Keeley, who delivered a massive hit on Liarakos right at the blue line. And that looks like, with 10 seconds left to go, that's going to do it. And a Thursday in Mississippi, the Mississippi Seawolves and Carolina. Its biggest loss of the season. Their final score from the Mississippi Coast Coliseum, the Seawolves. So that's how it looked and sounded here on Thunderbirds TV and on WTOB last night here at the Mississippi Coast Coliseum. Carolina now looking to respond. That loss last night was only their second loss here in Biloxi, as now Carolina looks to try to be able to find something here across the next 60 minutes of action coming up just past the top of the hour here this evening. Well, we'll take a look at the Carolina Thunderbirds on the other side of this timeout. Thunderbirds pregame continues after this. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
Maple Chase Golf and Country Club offers the best in recreational amenities in the Triad. Come enjoy a meal at the Pinebrook Bar and Grill, relax by our pool and cabana, and gear up at the Pro Shop while sharpening your skills on our 9,000 square foot putting green, and play around on our 18-hole Ellis Maples Design Championship Golf Course. You can find out more at MapleChaseCC.com. That's MapleChaseCC.com.
For over 85 years, Mustin and Crutchfield has been more than just a local market. We've been a proud part of North Carolina's heritage. When our founders started in 1938, they sourced meats from local farmers and groceries from small companies. Finding a way to stay competitive in this market has been a challenge through the years. Luckily, there are a lot of entrepreneurs, and now we have close to 50 local vendors that we feature. We're proud to partner with the Carolina Thunderbirds as a local sponsor, celebrating community values both on and off the ice. Mustin and Crutchfield, your hometown local grocer. When it comes to performance, speed matters, just like on the ice. Introducing same-day dental crowns right here at Twin Oaks Dentistry. With cutting-edge technology, we craft crowns on-site, eliminating the need for temporary. As proud sponsors of the Carolina Thunderbirds, we understand the need for top-notch performance. We're more than just dental care. We're your partners in achieving your best smile. Twin Oaks Dentistry, where technology.
We're getting you set for Carolina and Mississippi here on a Friday evening in at the Mississippi Coast Coliseum. Brennan Riley with you here on Thunderbirds TV and on WTOB. It's Mardi Gras night here at the Mississippi Coast Coliseum, with the Seawolves wearing specialty Mardi Gras uniforms here this evening. Believe also heard that during the first intermission there will be a Mardi Gras parade, because the first intermission is an extra 10 minutes here this evening. So about a 27-28 minute first intermission coming up here this evening for the Mississippi Coast Coliseum. It's time to take a look at the Carolina Thunderbirds coming into this evening, though, who are led by the head coach, Steve Harrison, who's got a record of 188, 126, and 17, 21, 7-1 here in his first year as the head coach of the Thunderbirds. And the FBHL's got a 128, 52, and 17 record. And now against Mississippi, he's 1-1-1. Thunderbirds are led here this season by Peter Panacic, who's got 45 points on the season, 7 goals and 38 assists for the Czech Republic native. Those 38 assists have him first in the FP HL here this season. He's had a streak of five straight games with a point snapped last night after he's had six across last weekend. He had four last Friday and had two on Saturday. Banachik, he went out during the second period last night. He got hit in the hand, got slashed in the hand. There was some swelling, but he said that he should be ready to go and he should give it a go here this evening. We'll have to see if he'll be able to go the full tilt here this evening, but Peter Banachik, as of right now, is scheduled to play here this evening. John Petita, he's had a good stretch here as of late here against this Seawolves team. He's got three goals and an assist across three games. He's also got six goals in his over his last five contests, including the hat trick back a few weeks ago. Petita now up to 22 points here for the Cleveland native, who's tonight is playing his 200th FPHL game of his career. Last night, Peter Banachik, he played in his 200th game, though. So both of those reaching the 250 mark across the three games last week, and now both reaching their 200th regular season game, that is, here this weekend in Biloxi. Cody Karpinski, he will start here tonight for the Carolina Thunderbirds after last night saved 24 out of 28 shots. He's got a 1-2 record with a 439 goals against average and an 856 save percentage for the Chicago native. He gets to start in net with Anthony Petrico, his backup here tonight, Yuri Pestuka. He had goals in each of his last three games going into last night. That was snapped. He had eight shots on goal last night. Also hit the bar twice as Pestuka. It was him and the rest of this Thunderbirds team. It was more of that same that Blake Weirich. He was terrific last night in net for this Mississippi Seawolves team. James Farmer, he's got a point in each of his last three games, as well as Joe Kenny's got a point in three out of his last four here this evening. One thing that keep an eye on in a story that might continue to develop here. During warm-ups, Jacob Schnapp was escorted off the ice by one of the officials. So he was taken off about 8-9 minutes left to go on the warm-up clock, and we'll have to see what that means. We haven't heard any word from up here in the booth. We'll have to see if anything comes to that and see if he comes out for the start here this evening. That's a look at the Carolina Thunderbirds coming in to tonight. The Mississippi Seawolves, the preview on them is coming up next. Thunderbirds pregame continues after this. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
Finish strong. Start here. Atrium Health Wake Forest Baptist.
Riddle Tractor has been selling and servicing tractors, mowers, and more for over 43 years. We stock over 50,000 parts and we service what we sell. Visit us at RiddleTractor.com. That's RiddleTractor.com. Equipping those who get the job done.
Hey Thunderbirds, are you looking for a metal building?
Here at Bulldog Steel Structures, we got you covered with multiple garages, barns, and styles you need.
Contact us today to get your free quote at 888-551-2156.
Or visit our website, www.bulldogsteelstructures.com, and mention the Thunderbirds and we'll give you a flying deal. God bless you.
Go Thunderbirds!
The Flow Garage app helps you keep up with your vehicles from anywhere. Flow customers can request service appointments, receive text and video updates, view sales and service history, receive recall notifications, and even get purchase offers via Flow Offer to Purchase. Download the app today.
Hey there, Triad Thunderbirds fans. Introducing Tee It Up Indoors, your ultimate golfing destination in Greensboro. With our cutting-edge golf simulators, you can tee off on world-class courses, no matter the weather. We're not just a golf facility. We're your partner in having a fantastic time. From golf lessons to corporate events, we've got it all covered. Plus, we even host birthday parties. Tee It Up Indoors, where golf meets excitement. Contact us today and swing into action.
Brendan Riley with you here on Thunderbirds TV and on WTOB as we continue to count you down for puck drop here for the fourth meeting this season between the two sides, taking a look at the Mississippi Seawolves here this season. Coming tonight with a 16-15-1 record, 45 points, currently in fourth in the Continental Division of the FPHL. They trail Port Huron by 2 points and picked up a win last night in Elmira. Yanni Liarancos, he has been a killer for the Thunderbirds. He's been a killer for a lot of teams as well here across the 2023-2024 season. 4 goals for Liarancos across the first 3 games here. He's also got 7 points as well, as he has been able to pick up an assist in every game this season. He got the scoring started last night in that 5-1 victory for Mississippi. Mississippi, they've now won 4 of their last 5. They're 10-7 here at home. And a real big storyline here across these 3 games has been the power play. And that being Mississippi's power play has been unreal. 6 power play chances for this Mississippi Seawolves team across the 3 games. They are 5-for-6 against the Thunderbirds, whose power play now sits at 73% here this year. That's second to last in the FBHL. Only Port Huron has a worse mark here this season. But the Seawolves here tonight, they get the return of Joe Pace Jr., who returns from suspension since after he was suspended back from games on January 12th. 4 assists for him here this season. Philip Wong's got 31 points for them. Joaquin Nielsen, 39, 20 goals and 19 assists. Haven't called Nielsen's name all that much here across these 3 games. Hugo Koch, though, he has been good. 22 goals and 22 assists for him here this season. Jackson Bond, he had a goal and an assist last night. 11 goals and 18 assists for him here this season. Also a celebrity player here this evening for the Mississippi Seawolves. It'll be Philip Wong's father, Tony Wong. He's in his 60s. He is the celebrity player here this evening for the Mississippi Seawolves here on their Mardi Gras night here at the Mississippi Coast Coliseum. Starting in net here this evening for the Seawolves will be Blake Weirich, who got the start last night, say 46 out of 47 shots in his first start since all the way back on December 30th. He's only made 4 starts since December 1st, but he was terrific last night. He ended up picking up second star honors and is a big reason why last night went the way it did. So he gets the start for the second straight night. See if the Thunderbirds can get success for the second time in a row against a Seawolves goalie. They were able to do it last Saturday against Anthony D'Aloisio back on Saturday in the 4-2-1 over for more of the same here this evening. That's a look at the Mississippi Seawolves coming in to tonight. We'll take a timeout and take a look at the scoreboard and the out-of-town scores across the FPHL. After this, this is Thunderbirds Hockey.
Get ready, Winston-Salem. Jennifer Sapp, your trusted realtor and broker since 1997, puts the real in realtor, and she's proud to be a sponsor of your Carolina Thunderbirds. As a top producer and your go-to realtor for all your real estate needs, Jennifer Sapp is ready to help you score your dream home goal. Call Jennifer at 336-782-3148 or visit her at jennifersapp.allenton.com.
Once upon a time, not so far away, two heroes found the secret to a perfect game day. They had heard of a baker. One with big heart, they were thrilled he had the answer. Ava's Cupcakes is where he's set to start.
From cakes to cookies, cupcakes, and more, we've got flavors that'll score and score.
So the Thunderbirds cheered, ready to tell all. Ava's Cupcakes is the sweetest. Bakery to call.
Finish strong. Start here. Atrium Health Wake Forest Baptist.
Flo Cadillac is a proud sponsor of the Carolina Thunderbirds. Visit 1400 South Stratford Road for a free test drive. Or go online to flocadillac.com to schedule a sales or service appointment.
Closing in on puck drop, Carolina in Mississippi here on a Friday evening at the Mississippi Coast Coliseum. Brendan Riley with you here on Thunderbirds pregame. Time to take a look around the out-of-town scoreboard here on a Friday evening. A lot of action already underway. We start at First Arena, Elmira, New York. It's a 2-1 lead for the Port Huron Prowlers, who picked up the victory last night. Mitch Jones has found the back of the net, as well as Brett Parker for Elmira, before Sam Merritt gave him the lead with about 8.5 minutes to go there in that first period. Looking elsewhere from Watertown Arena in Watertown, New York, Binghamton in Watertown squaring off, and it's Binghamton with the lead thanks to Tyson Kirkby's goal just 49 seconds into the first period there. They're about 8.5 minutes there into that one in Watertown. Columbus in Baton Rouge from the Columbus Civic Center, and it's the River Dragons thanks to Cody Wickline's goal just about 6 minutes into the first period, as the River Dragons in front there in that one. And then the final game here this evening from Big Boy Arena, Motor City and Blue Ridge battling. It's the Rockers, a 1-0 lead there. Scott Koesch found the back of the net just over 14 minutes into the first there. That's a look, the pregame look around the rest of the FPHL here this evening. Take a look at the lines coming up on the other side of this, and then it'll be time for puck drop. Carolina and Mississippi for the second time here this weekend. We're back after this. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
Maple Chase Golf and Country Club offers the best in recreational amenities in the Triad.
Come enjoy a meal at the Pine Brook Bar and Grill, relax by our pool and cabana, and gear up at the Pro Shop while sharpening your skills on our 9,000 square foot putting green, and play around on our 18-hole Ellis Maples Design Championship Golf Course. You can find out more at MapleChaseCC.com. That's MapleChaseCC.com.
Here at Comtech, we think it shouldn't cost a fortune to have peace of mind. That's why we bring you the latest in smart home protection and home monitoring at prices you can afford. Already paying for home monitoring? We can beat it. Give us a call today or visit us at ctpower.com. That's ctpower.com. Comtech, your one stop for security, fire, cameras, and more.
Graybrook Technologies is located in downtown Winston-Salem near the Dash Stadium. We specialize in automation, integration, and motor control with our team of dedicated engineers, a UL industrial control panel shop, and our warehouse packed with VFDs and components to fabricate the custom controls your company needs. Graybrook is a preferred partner with Danfoss, Siemens, Schneider Square D, and others, to bring your project to life with brands you know and trust. Visit our website at graybrook.com or call us at 336-310-9092 to learn more about the array of services we offer.
Let's go Birds!
Back here in Biloxi, we are just about set for puck drop. Time to take a look at the starters for the Carolina Thunderbirds here this evening. It'll be Joe Kennedy and Clay Keeley, the defenseman here tonight. Jacob Schnapp, he is out on the ice and is starting here this evening. He's joined by Zach Horn and Nate Keeley here as Carolina goes with Cody Karpinski in net for the second time here this weekend. Carolina and Mississippi, puck drop. It's on the other side of this timeout. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
When it comes to performance, speed matters, just like on the ice. Introducing same-day dental crowns right here at Twin Oaks Dentistry. With cutting-edge technology, we craft crowns on-site, eliminating the need for temporary. As proud sponsors of the Carolina Thunderbirds, we understand the need for top-notch performance. We're more than just dental care. We're your partners in achieving your best smile. Twin Oaks Dentistry, where technology.
Proud sponsor of the Carolina Thunderbirds, Parrish Tire and Automotive, your reliable, local, and honest choice. In Winston-Salem, Mount Airy, Dobson, Jonesville, and Clemens. Go Birds!
Once upon a time, not so far away, two heroes found the secret to a perfect game day. They had heard of a baker. One with big heart, they were thrilled he had the answer. Ava's Cupcakes is where he's set to start. From cakes to cookies, cupcakes, and more, we've got flavors that'll score and score. So the Thunderbirds cheered, ready to tell all. Ava's Cupcakes is the sweetest. Bakery to call.
For over 85 years, Mustin and Crutchfield has been more than just a local market. We've been a proud part of North Carolina's heritage. When our founders started in 1938, they sourced meats from local farmers and groceries from small companies. Finding a way to stay competitive in this market has been a challenge through the years. Luckily, there are a lot of entrepreneurs, and now we have close to 50 local vendors that we feature. We're proud to partner with the Carolina Thunderbirds as a local sponsor, celebrating community values both on and off the ice. Mustin and Crutchfield, your hometown local grocer.
Back here in Biloxi, time for our national anthem.
One so proudly we hailed, and the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets.
Our national anthem here at the Mississippi Coast Coliseum. We are set for puck drop here on a Friday evening in Biloxi, Mississippi. Carolina and the Mississippi Seawolves for the fourth time this season. Brendan Riley with you here high above ice sign. Here getting ready to bring you what should be a fun one here this evening. Carolina looking for a response here tonight, and they're hoping to get that as they have so many times this season. Cody Karpinski, he's the starting netminder here tonight for the Carolina Thunderbirds, who have a record of 21-7 in one and second place in the Continental Division of the FPHL. On the other side, it'll be Blake Wyrick making the start here this evening for the Mississippi Seawolves. Last night, he ended up saving 46 out of 47 shots. Big reason as to why Mississippi came away with the 5-1 victory. Should be another fun one here this evening. Carolina will start with their third line, Zach Horn, Nate Keeley, and Jacob Schnapp, the defenseman Joe Kennedy, and Clay Keeley to start things off for Steve Harrison here tonight. Steve Harrison comes into this evening with a career record of 188, 126, and 17, 21, 7, and 1 here in his first season. In his first season in Carolina. Carolina leads the all-time series 13-3, and we are set for puck drop here in our first bank, first period. Should be a fun one here on a Friday night in Biloxi, and the faceoff is won by Mississippi, and we're underway here from the Mississippi Coast Coliseum. Mississippi wearing Mardi Gras sweaters here this evening as they have their Mardi Gras night here tonight, and it starts with the puck trickling all the way in down behind Cody Karpinski's net. A good hit by Joe Kennedy as he's able to dispossess Philip Wong. Wong shoves a man into the board. Schnapp a quick touch, and now here comes Zach Horn up the near side. Horn backhands one in, and it's saved by Wyrick, and he freezes here just 27 seconds into this one. Interesting sweaters. You got the green and yellow. You got white numbers. But Carolina in their traditional road white uniforms here this evening. They bring out Jan Salak, John Batita, Fabian Granquist, Clay Keeley, and Joe Kennedy stay out there. Face off, Batita ties up on it. It's taken behind the net and played out the near half boards. A quick touch by Danny Lacio, he shovels it up near side on the back end. Good touch by Clay Keeligan. A poke check in. Jan Salak trying to join now as Granquist takes it away. Backhands it to Salak and walks up the near side into the attacking zone. He's battling against Sam Turner, who has it behind the net. Pass intercepted by Batidu. Backhands one, trying to get it in. Puck bounces over towards the corner. Lynn trying to clear the zone. He can't. But Sita loses it, and it comes all the way back out. Clay Keeley chasing. He has Dmitry Kuznetsov on him. And a stretch pass comes to Granquist. Carolina in the midst of a change. Batidu will chase after it. Picking it up is Matt Stoya, who added a goal and an assist last night. Stoya in his own defensive zone flutters one out to the neutral zone. Liarakos lost his stick, and he was offside as he had to go pick it up. And a stoppage here with 18:39 to go in the first period. Last night, Mississippi, they got the scoring started very quickly. They scored just 2 minutes and 45 seconds into the game. They have Nielsen, Koch, and Liarakos, the forwards. Face off across from the Thunderbirds bench. It's one and a quick slap shot from the red line by Matt Stoya's glove down by Karpinski. He tried to shovel it away. A shot goes high over his glove and rattles over near side. Nielsen throws one out in front. It was behind Koch, though, and goes all the way down. Here with 18:20 left to go in the first period. Carolina and Mississippi for the fourth time this season, second time here this weekend. These two sides will see each other in the middle of February back here in Biloxi. Pastuca takes it away in the neutral zone. There you see Peter Manacic getting his first shift here tonight after he went out last night during the second period, and an icing is called. Manacic, he got slashed in the hand. He's animated heading back to the bench, kicked his glove. Animated about that, a little frustration as well, but Manacic, he was more or less the game time decision here tonight, but told Steve Harrison about an hour before puck drop that he would be ready to go. Defensive zone faceoff win for Carolina, but it's wrapped around by Mississippi. In the near corner, Justin Bione plays the body, takes a hit as a man loses his stick. Puck still in the corner, though, as Lucas Helen delivering the blow to Bione. Quick shot from the point, takes a deflection. Karpinski shovels it away. James Farmer goes down behind the play from his knee, sends a pass to Yuri Pastuca, who backhands it, almost gets it to Banachik. And instead, we have a quick stoppage, and we're going to have a tripping call. It's going to go against Philip Wong here, 17:35 left to go here in the first bank, first period. So Carolina to the power play for the first time here tonight. With 17:35 to go here in the first period. Jan Salak, he's in for the draw against Yanni Liarakos. They tangle up, Schnapp steps in, takes it, and sends it back out to the point. Manacic, he has it, he toes the blue line, backhands it to Bastuca. Bastuca waits, his shot goes off the heel of Liarakos, looked to be in a little bit of pain, stays on his feet, and it's sent back out to Salak, sends it far side. He gets it right back from Peter Vanacek. Pastuca walks in the slot, sends one in, a centering pass, and it gets deflected away. Goes off at Salak and is kept in the zone. Schnapp gets it out to Pastuca, slides it to Salak. Far side Vanacek. He surveys at the half boards. Here are 17 minutes to go here in the first period. Another early power play for Carolina. Pastuca shot, save, rebound was loose. Dumas couldn't get a stick to it. Weirich shoveled it away, but Carolina holds on to it. Back at the point, Vanacek, top of the circles. He waits, sends it to Salak near side, trying to get a centering pass in. It was knocked away by Lambert. Schnapp holding, sends it to Dumas. Dumas steps out in front of the backhand. His shot goes through the crease. Here's Pastuca, good pressure here on this power play, the little Italy power play for the Thunderbirds. Manacic waits, slides Salak, a one-timer, and a save by Weirich. Oh, a great set there on the power play for Carolina, who came in tonight at 27% on the season, good for third in the FPHL. Couple of really good looks there. But a good save by Blake Weirich, who saved 46 out of 47 last night. 50 seconds remain here on the power play for Carolina. Petito wins the draw, and they will do it again. Decent crowd on hand here at the Mississippi Coast Coliseum. Last night, flood warnings, tornado warning as well. Had fans stay home. Kennedy off of the draw. Gets tangled up. A clearing attempt held in by Batsita. Leaves it for James Farmer. He's got an assist in each of his last three games. Kennedy steps through a defenseman, pokes it along to Nate Keeley behind the net. Keeley back hands it out to his twin brother Clay at the point. Clay banks a pass. It goes off the skate of Nate, and Vatita picks it up. Back out to Kennedy. Kennedy waits, slides it over Farmer one to one timer, but sends a return pass instead. Kennedy sends it cross corner. Nate Keeley has it. Keeley behind the net, back out to Kennedy with 16 seconds remaining on the power play. Clay Keeley in the corner. He's pinned to the boards. They battle for it. Batita trying to get to it. He does. He waits, trying to fend a man off on his back. Batita behind the net. Great power play here, Carolina, though. Not able to find the back of the net as Wong's out. Here's Keeley. A shot, and it goes off of the glove of Wyrick and trickles into the corner. Stoya flips it along. But taken away is Nate Keeley. Tries to center one. Gets knocked down. Wong whacking away at it, and he clears the zone. This one's going to go all the way down. Will it have enough for icing? And it will. So the power play is killed off by Mississippi, but Carolina quickly with five shots here in this one. ...15-15 remains here in the first period. Carolina now 3-for-11 across now the last four games against the Seawolves penalty kill. Faceoff is won in the defensive zone by Mississippi. Stoya's pass up the near side goes by Dalton Anderson as Justin Bione collects on the forehand. Plays a bank pass, goes off of the linesman, and Mississippi trying to go the other way. Dumas a quick touch before Bione gets it back. Under 15 to go here in the first period. Bione taken down behind the plate, but Pastuca walks in, tries to float it to Dumas, who takes it. Dumas to Pastuca. Gets bumped by Connor Lynn as now the puck still loose. Pastuca plays a bank pass back to the point. Bione, he holds. He'll cycle it over for a corner. Dumas chasing after it. Spins away from a man, trying to throw it in front. Instead, it's poked away at the point. It's kept in by Curtis Heggie. So he dumps it in. Pastuca battling against Lynn. Lynn wins the one-on-one battle. He takes it in his own slot. He had Banachik closing on him, but shovels one out on the far side. A quick look and a nice shot by Heggie taking him down, but the hand goes up. A delayed penalty coming up, and Mississippi's going to be going to the power play for the first time here this evening with 14-13 remaining here in period number one. Good start for the Thunderbirds. Haven't been able to find the back of the net. They've looked good so far, but Curtis Heggie, he's going off for 2 minutes when we return. We've reached left to go. We've reached a media timeout. We're back to Biloxi after this. No score, Carolina, Mississippi. This is Thunderbirds hockey.
When it comes to performance, speed matters, just like on the ice. Introducing same-day dental crowns right here at Twin Oaks Dentistry. With cutting-edge technology, we craft crowns on-site, eliminating the need for temporary. As proud sponsors of the Carolina Thunderbirds, we understand the need for top-notch performance. We're more than just dental care. We're your partners in achieving your best smile. Twin Oaks Dentistry. We're taking...
Back here in Biloxi, Carolina, in Mississippi. Scoreless here with 14-13 left to go here in the first period. And it'll be Mississippi going to the power play after Curtis Heggie is called for interference. So Carolina will bring out the penalty kill for the first time here this evening. With Mississippi on the power play. Mississippi, the power play at 22%, sixth in the league. Carolina, though, second to last in that PHL at 73%. This is the seventh power play opportunity for Mississippi here over this four-game stretch. They are 5-for-6. A couple power play goals last night. Two to be exact. They went 2-for-2 on the power play last night. And it starts with a face-off to the right of Cody Karpinski. It's one. Joe Kennedy tries to clear the zone. It's held in, though, at the point by Sam Turner. Shovels it over far side. Wong battling against Kennedy. The guy's whacking at the skates. It's tied up in the skates. It comes free and comes back out. A quick pass out to Liarakos. He whiffs on a one-timer, chasing after it near side and clearing it all the way down. For a second was James Farmer. Didn't get all the way down. It was held in right at the blue line. Kennedy dumps this one down, takes a late check as now K Carolina will get a quick change. Liorakos quickly the other way. His pass intercepted by Farmer. See the physicality here early on for Mississippi. Here's Koch. Koch one-on-one drops it for Stoya. Stoya goes cross ice. Here's a center. He passed a one-timer. It didn't get all the way through. It's blocked in front. Leone tries to clear, and he will clear the zone. Liorakos couldn't keep it in here with 13 minutes left to go here in the first period and 48 seconds remaining on the penalty kill after Curtis Hege was calling for interference. Liorakos holds at it, the near point. Slides it top of the zone. A shot from Kuznetsov, and it's saved by Karpinski, who covers with 12:52 left to go here in the first period. Karpinski trying to settle in here with the Thunderbirds. Had a good start last Saturday against the Seawolves team after he gave up 7 last Wednesday. He has a faceoff to his left, and it's 1 back out to the point. Connor Lind toes the blue line. On the forehand, sends it near side. Koch sends one wide. Trying to get a deflection was Wong. He chases after it now into the near half boards. Koch, with Kennedy all over him, drops it off. A centering pass, puck bouncing around. Karpinski got a blocker there, and it's cleared all the way down. 13 seconds to go here on the penalty kill for Carolina. One last chance maybe for Mississippi. Koch slides it over to Nielsen into the attacking zone. Nielsen angled off by Joe Kennedy. Delivers a nice hip check. Farmer spins away. Hege out of the box. We're back to 5-on-5 action. Farmer zipped it all the way down, and icing is called. That one almost in the head of Curtis Hege, who's just coming out of the box. And so now you got 3 defensemen out there with Hege just out of the box with Schnapp and Nate Keeley. Carolina going to try to get a quick change here and try to clear the zone. 12:06 remains here in the first period. Defensive zone faceoff win for the Thunderbirds. Hege dumps it out to the neutral zone. Carolina looking to get a change. Up the far side, a pass by Lambert. Shoveled along. Schnapp right in front of the linesman takes a hit. On the near side, a quick pass gets deflected into the far corner by Helen. Farmer picks it up, spins, tries to spin away, but it's poked away. Here's Wong, centering pass, and they score. With 11:36 left to go here in the first period, a one-timer right in front. Beats Karpinski high over the shoulder. And it's Jackson Bond getting his 2nd of the weekend and 12th on the year. And Mississippi takes their 1-0 lead here in the first. Now here's a chance right at the draw. Here's a shot save. Pasuka, he can't get the rebound to go. A centering pass and they score. Peter Banachik after Carolina catches them sleeping, coming right off of the draw. It went to Dumas, to Pasuka, and Pasuka is able to backhand it back out right in front. And Peter Banachik, he gets his 8th goal of the season and picks up his team-leading 46 point here with 11:27 left to go here in the first. Carolina ties it up just 9 seconds later after Jackson Bond gave the home sign. The 1-0 lead. So 1-1, just like that. Jackson Bond with 11:36 to go. Peter Banachik with 11:27 to go in the first period. We're tied at 1 here between Carolina and Mississippi. That's the response he needed if you're the Thunderbirds. Puck is dumped all the way down. Kennedy races after it, and it's an icing. That goal from Peter Banachik, a Riddle tractor goal. The 7:59 mark. Jackson Bond from Philip Wong made it 1-0. A few seconds later, Peter Banachik from Dominic Dumas and Yuri Pastuka have us tied up at 1. Faceoff is 1 back to the point. Hege keeps it in, banks a pass off of the boards. Jan Salak loses an edge. Greenquist tries to step up. Batita tries to knock it back out in front. Instead, Stoya takes it in the near corner. 10:53 to go. Batita trying to dance through him, and Salak takes it, dumps it into the corner. Granquist drops it off for Salak. New circle, sends it far side. Here's Kennedy, a quick shot, save, rebound comes out near side. Batita leaves it for Salak. His shot gets blocked by Stoya. Batita just trying to send one in. It's knocked down, though, by Sam Turner. Stoya kicks it over far side. Here with 10.5 to go. Mississippi just able to clear the zone. Justin Barr loses it. Joe Kennedy picks it up. Carolina, they got their first goal over the halfway mark of last night's game. What a good response here. Kennedy, a quick shot, goes into the skates of Sam Turner. Puck comes out in front. Schnapp trying to whack at it. Now in the corner, Petita ties a man up. On the far side, Kyle Russell slides it up, puts it off the back heels of a man, and dumps it in. Karpinski gets a touch, lays it out near side. No one was home, though, at the point. Philip Wong sends it into the corner. Carolina trying to get it out of their own zone here at 9:44 left to go in the first period. The point, a quick shot. It's gloved by Karpinski, and he'll freeze here at 9:37 left to go here in the first period. Carolina able to tie it up just 9 seconds after Jackson Bond gave Mississippi the early 1-0 lead. We reached immediate timeout. Carolina and Mississippi tied up at 1 here in Biloxi, and we're back to the Mississippi Coast Coliseum after this. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
I want Huey to live a long, happy life. I give him supplements to take care of his joints. He's on preventatives to keep the fleas and ticks away. It's the same with my Subaru Outback. He takes care of us every day, and when we go on adventures, we get our Outback serviced by the experts at Flo Subaru of Winston-Salem. I love my Subaru, and I know it will live a long and happy life if I treat it right, just like Huey.
We're back here in Biloxi, Carolina, Mississippi, tied at 1. And it's been a tale of really two seasons so far for this Thunderbirds team. They started off 16-3-0, second best start ever in franchise history. And they're the first in the division on December 23rd. Now, since then, Carolina 5-4-1, including their largest loss of the season last night, a 5-1 loss. And so Carolina going through struggles, but are trying to figure it out here tonight. Over that stretch, Carolina has given up 4.2 goals per game. They suffered their largest loss last night while scoring four goals per game here this season. One of those games, though, 9 goals against Port Huron back on January 6th. But also across this series, they've allowed 5 power play goals and have allowed a shorthanded goal as well. We're back underway here in the first period. 9:33 remains. Carolina and Mississippi tied up at 1. James Former slides it over far side. Carolina able to clear the zone. Horn shovels it along before he gets sent down right in front of his own, in front of the Mississippi bench. Farmer backhands it along, though. Nate Keeley in the far corner sends one in front. Horn, a shot, and it goes wide. Schnapp cycles it back in. Horn tries to spin away. Good hit there by Nate Keeley on the near side. Schnapp chasing after it. Centers one. It just goes a little too far for Nate Keeley to pick it up. Nielsen will send a stretch pass over far side. Not enough on it for icing here with under 9 minutes to go here in the first period, which is brought to you by First Bank. Farmer will tap this one in. Carolina gets off for a change. Tyson Lambert holds behind his own cage, and his netminder, Blake Wyrick, who saved 7 of 8 shots so far. On the other side, Cody Karpinski saved 6 of 7. They battle for it. Pokes free into the zone. Lacio. Over Liorakos, a backhand. Sticked away by Karpinski. Centering pass coming in near side. Liorakos picks it up. He has it on the backhand in the far corner. Brings it out. Centers one. Here's Lambert walking in. A shot, save, rebound in front. And it's deflected wide. Lacio wasn't able to finish. Carolina now looking for a stretch pass. Here they come, 2-on-1. Banacic with Dumas. Banacic waiting. A shot and a save by Wyrick. Nielsen quickly the other way. These two sides going back and forth. It's Strott, Lacio. He waits, trying to get it to Liarakos. Too much on it. Curtis Hege finishes off a hit on Lacio as now Carolina looks to break. Here they come, 3-on-2 if they hurry. Pastuca over to Banacic with Dumas. A shot, and that one goes high. Lacio and Dumas battle for it at the half boards. A man loses his stick. It looks like Dumas had his stick snapped in half. 7:37 left to go here in the first period. It's dumped in Karpinski, who has it in the trapper, and he covers here with 7:33 to go in the first. Reminder that the first intermission here tonight is an extended first intermission because it's Mardi Gras night here in Biloxi. They added an extra 10 minutes to the clock. I believe they're doing a Mardi Gras parade. Alton Anderson and Salak for the draw. Carolina wins it. And on the far side, Batita gets rid of it quickly to Jan Salak. He's sitting on 199 assists in his FBHL career. Granqvist kind of tangled up in his skates. Batita sends this one all the way back down. Kennedy spinning into the corner. Lost an edge as he had a man pressuring. A quick shot from Stoyas, blocked by Salak. He looks for it. Anderson trying to shovel it along. Batita instead delivers a stretch pass. Granqvist backhands it over to Salak. Takes a hop, and Stoya sends it far side. Kennedy steps up on the forecheck. Salak gets a touch, just reached out the stick. Here's Salak, top of the slot, and a save by Wyrick. Batita trying to shovel it along. Batita, he got his stick snapped. Two times now here over the last stretch, the Thunderbirds had a stick snapped. As Mississippi tries to go the other way. An interception, though. Salak, he got a touch to it. A shot and a save by Karpinski. Puck bouncing around in the slot. Kennedy shovels it along. Horn played it high off of the glass, and now it's tangled up over at the half board. 6:20 to go here in the first period. Carolina and Mississippi tied up at 1. Jackson Bond and Peter Bonacci with goals 9 seconds apart from each other. Shots are 11-10 in favor of Mississippi on our Comtech LLC shots on goal tracker. Here in our first bank, first period. Kennedy, he'll take his time holding behind the net. Some boos and jeers coming down from the crowd here in Mississippi. Bione snaps one up to Schnapp. He got a deflection. He chases after it into the corner. Turner throws a pass. It goes off with a broken stick and comes all the way back out to the neutral zone. Another stretch, Bione threw it behind Schnapp, and this is going to be an icing. There are 5:35 to go here in the first. The faceoff comes to the right of Cody Karpinski. Faceoffs won by Nate Keeley as Carolina tries to clear the zone, though. Pass deflected along. Bione takes it at the red line. Dumps it in cross corner. Wyrick wanted an icing, but no call. Lambert backhands it all the way out to James Farmer. 5:18 to go here in the first. Bione plays a touch pass, trying to get it to Schnapp. It's whacked along by Nate Keeley. Schnapp battling in the corner. Comes out to the half board. Sam Turner trying to clear the zone. He does, as Bione just about a half step away. He now has some space, brings it in, sends one high over the glove of Wyrick. Nate Keeley in the corner, shoved into by Tyson Lambert. It's sent back out to the point. Here's Farmer, a shot. It goes off a Schnapp in front. Nielsen will float it out. Jackson Bond will play a back pass. And a stoppage. Mississippi might have had an extra man on. But 4:41 remains here in the first period. Carolina and Mississippi, this game's starting to open up just a little bit. And we're tied up at 1 here. 4:41 to go here in the first at the Mississippi Coast Coliseum. We're back to Biloxi on the other side of this timeout. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
Hey there, Triad Thunderbirds fan. Introducing Tee It Up Indoors, your ultimate golfing destination in Greensboro. With our cutting-edge golf simulators, you can tee off on world-class courses, no matter the weather. We're not just a golf facility. We're your partner in having a fantastic time. From golf lessons to corporate events,
we've got it all covered. Plus, we even host birthday parties, tee it up indoors, where golf meets excitement. Contact us today and swing into action.
One here in this one. Shots on goal are 11-10 in our Comtech LLC shots on goal tracker. It looks like Tony Wong is going to be in the penalty box as Mississippi's called for a penalty. Carolina's going to go to a little Italy power play. Tony Wong, the father of Philip Wong, is a celebrity. Celebrity player here this evening for the Mississippi Seawolves here on their Mardi Gras night. And so Carolina's going to go to the power play for the second time here this evening. So Carolina with the opportunity to take their first lead of the evening here on the power play. It starts with Peter Menacek at the blue line. Fakes a pass to Vistuka and instead rattles it around. Jacob Schnott behind the net, sends it all the way back out. Vistuka. Salak now, top of the circle, slides it to Schnapp, trying to throw it in front. Got deflected down by Lynn. He picks it up, sends it over far side. Menacek, who's got the goal here tonight for Carolina. Schnapp all the way back to the point. Vistuka, a shot. It's battled around in front. Dumas trying to get to it. Instead, Justin Barr will dump it all the way down. Too many men, the call. With Tony Wong serving it. Born in 1961. Menacek trying to slide one across, and said it goes off the leg of Danny Lacio. Salak darting after it. Leaves it for Schnapp. Schnapp trying to backhand one in. It's picked up behind the net. Dumas to Salak, back out to the point. A quick touch pass over far inside to Peter Menacek. Menacek to Schnapp. They're in front. Schnapp a shot. It's blocked by Lind. Lind gets the loose puck. And he'll send it back out to the neutral zone. Good look there for Jacob Schnapp in front. He's quickly back into the zone. Slides it over to Jan Salak. Two goals away from 100 in his Thunderbirds career. Salak back out to the point. Menacek over far side. A shot. That one goes off a leg in front from Clay Keeley. Salak. Back to Menacek. They stay on side. Here's Schnapp near side. Schnapp trying to find a centering pass. Stoy went down to a knee and kept it out. Salak still has it, though. Another good threat here on the power play. A tip from Dumas goes wide. Schnapp takes it, though. Salak at the near half board sends it back out. The hand is up. Carolina's going to have another delayed power play. On the far side, puck's continuing to bounce around. Petita, he's just out of the box. 4 seconds to go here on the man advantage. Carolina's going to have another fresh 2 minutes. Hand is still up. Salak, top of this line, leaves it. Keeley, his shot goes wide. And now it will finally be touched, and it looks like a slash is going to be called. With 2:31 left to go here in the first, Carolina's going to get another power play opportunity.
What y'all know about Mardi Gras up there, yeah? What up on the intersection, A? How you doing tonight?
Stoya is going to be going off for a slash. With Carolina back to the power play.
Let's go.
1-1 your score here, 2:31 remains. Carolina with their second unit out there after the first unit was out there pretty much the whole 2 minutes. Faceoff is tied up in the near half boards. Farmer trying to pick it up. Instead, it's cleared all the way down. Kyle Russell was able to go into the scrum and take it away. Just over 2 minutes to go here in the first. Carolina to their third Little Italy power play here this evening. Clay Keeley. Through the neutral zone. Tries to backhand one in. Instead, Sam Turner takes it away. He'll hold and he'll wait for Carolina to come before he sends this one all the way down. Karpinski, a quick touch. Sends it to Joe Kennedy. Minute 20 to go on the power play for Carolina. The slashing call against Matt Stoyan. Kennedy, his shot gets deflected behind the net. Clearing attempt. And it's sent all the way down by Russell. Carolina will change here just about with 90 seconds to go here in the first period. Minute to go on the power play. They're trying to get that first unit back out there. They're in the midst of the change. Clay Keeley, he has to retreat. He's got Lucas Helland all over him. Bonacic sends a stretch pass. Dumas couldn't settle it down. It's sent back into the skates of Clay Keeley. Liaracco sends it all the way back. Sam Turner. They'll dump this one to Liaracco's at the blue line here with 35 seconds to go on the power play. Carolina still without a shot here on this one. Jan Salak trying to change that. Slides it over to Dumas. Backhands it with 1 minute to go here in the first period. We're tied at one here between Carolina and Mississippi. Schnapp sends it far side. Salak, a shot, and it's blocked and deflects high into the corner. 17 seconds to go on the power play. Man lost an edge. That's Bonacic, and it's sent all the way down here at 10 seconds to go on the Stoya slashing call. Karpinski, a quick stretch pass. Bonacic drops it back. Salak battling for it. Has it on the far side. 2 seconds and one. Man out of the box. Back to 5-on-5 with 30 seconds to go here in the first period. Lind lost the stick. Schnapp and Salak battle for it in the corner. Salak can't come away with it as Stoya pokes it along. 20 seconds left to go here in the first. One last chance for Mississippi here in a tie game. It's floated along. Stoya, he's not able to get to it as Karpinski got the left pad there. Here's a chance, though. A quick shot and a save by Karpinski. And he covers with 8 seconds left to go. So Carolina with nearly 4 straight minutes on the power play. Not able to find anything. They're now 0 for 3 here tonight. 8 seconds to go here in the first period. Face off to the left of Cody Karpinski. Liaracco's for the draw against Nate Keeley. Liaracco's tried to send it in on it. Pioni takes it away here with 4 seconds left to go on the far side. One last shot goes wide. And that will do it for the first period. An entertaining first 20 minutes of action here at the Mississippi Coast Coliseum. Both sides with goals coming 9 seconds apart. Jackson Bond made it a 1-0 game. Vorbeter Bonacic tied us up. And after the first 20 minutes of action here at the Mississippi Coast Coliseum, Carolina and Mississippi are tied at one. Reminder that this first intermission report is an extended first intermission due to it being Mardi Gras night here at the Mississippi Coast Coliseum. Usually 18 minutes for an intermission. They're showing 28 minutes up on the clock here at the Mississippi Coast Coliseum. Heard that there's going to be a Mardi Gras parade here at some point across the next 28 minutes of action or so. So we have an extended first intermission report coming up here in just a little bit. 1-1 your score here between Carolina and Mississippi here in the 4th straight meeting between the two sides. The first intermission report starts on the other side of this timeout. 1-1 your score after 20. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
When it comes to performance, speed matters, just like on the ice. Introducing same-day dental crowns right here at Twin Oaks Dentistry. With cutting-edge technology, we craft crowns on-site, eliminating the need for temporary. As proud sponsors of the Carolina Thunderbirds, we understand the need for top-notch performance. We're more than just dental care. We're your partners in achieving your best smile. Twin Oaks Dentistry, where technology. Here at ComTech, we think it shouldn't cost a fortune to have peace of mind. That's why we bring you the latest in smart home protection and home monitoring at prices you can afford. Already paying for home monitoring? We can beat it. Give us a call today or visit us at ctpower.com. That's ctpower.com. ComTech, your one stop for security, fire, cameras, and more.
Once upon a time, not so far away, two heroes found the secret to a perfect game day. They had heard of a baker, one with big heart. They were thrilled he had the answer. Ava's Cupcakes is where he's set to start. From cakes to cookies, cupcakes, and more, we've got flavors that'll score and score. So the Thunderbirds cheered, ready to tell all. Ava's Cupcakes is the sweetest. Bakery to call. Tractor has been selling and servicing tractors, mowers, and more for over 43 years. We stock over 50,000 parts, and we service what we sell. Visit us at RiddleTractor.com. That's RiddleTractor.com, equipping those who get the job done.
We've reached the first intermission here in Biloxi. Carolina and Mississippi are tied up at one after the first 20 minutes of action here at the Mississippi Coast Coliseum on your Friday evening. Brendan Riley with you here on Thunderbirds TV and on WTOB. And we have about 25 and a half minutes until the start of the second period. Here in Biloxi, it is Mardi Gras night here at the Mississippi Coast Coliseum. And so we have an extended first intermission report here in this one. I believe that they're going to do a Mardi Gras parade. Oh, yes, they are. They're watching on Thunderbirds TV. You see those cars getting ready, and the cars and trucks getting ready to come out onto the ice out from the Zamboni corner down on the left side, or in the far left corner here at the rink in Mississippi. And sold about an hour before puck drop that this extended intermission was going to happen when I went down and talked to the head coach, Steve Harrison, one last time before coming back up here to the booth for pregame. But a 28-minute intermission, and it was a pretty entertaining first 20 minutes of action. And so to see that kind of be delayed here, a little bit tough there, especially for a Carolina team who are on the road. You know, that legs can always be a factor on the road, and that, you know, the tiredness from the drive can always play. Sometimes you just want to keep going. Usually you get the 18 minutes, but 28 minutes here this evening as now the parade has started.
And you want some beans, you want some pros, get on your feet, hit loud, and make some noise!
Of course, Mardi Gras coming up here in just a little bit. Coming up in a few Tuesdays as they're throwing beads out into the crowd. And a good crowd on hand, better crowd than we had last night. It was pouring rain here in Biloxi last night after it was flash flood warnings, or there was a tornado warning as well. And so also a Thursday night also can make it a little tough, but better crowd here for Mardi Gras night. But an entertaining first 20 minutes of action here at the Mississippi Coast Coliseum. The shots on goal are Comtech LLC. Shots on goal tracker. Mississippi out shooting Carolina for the first time in a period this weekend, 13-11. Cody Karpinski has saved 12 out of 13 shots. He's seen here tonight. Blake Weirich has saved 10 out of 11. The scoring here in this one, Jackson Bond. He started the scoring just over 8 minutes in with an assist from Philip Wong and a one-timer that went over the shoulder of Karpinski. They made a 1-0 game. They beat Banachik just moments later off the ensuing draw. Carolina got in 2-on-1 off of the draw. It was Dumas and Pastuca going in. Pastuca, he tried to get a shot away. It ended up being deflected behind the net. He stayed with it, and it was thrown back out in front, and Peter Vanacek was able to finish it off as that tied us up at one at the 8:33 mark there in the first period. Pastuca getting his 18th assist on the season. Dumas getting his 13th assist here this year with Peter Vanacek, who is really a game-time decision here this evening. He gets his 8th goal of the year and his team-leading 45th point here this season. Last night, he had a stretch of 5 straight games with a point snap, so he's now got a point in 6 out of his last 7, has 7 points across now, 3 games in a period here against Mississippi this season. Carolina and Mississippi right now, they're in a 1-1 game here at the Mississippi Coast Coliseum, as there is a spectacle down on the ice right now. You got trucks. Got some golf carts. Looks like a converted Mini Cooper. All driving around with fans trying to get beads here at the Mississippi Coast Coliseum. 1-1 your score, though. Still just under 22 minutes left to go until the start of the second period here in Biloxi here in a 1-1 game. Last night, the 5-1 win for Mississippi. Carolina trying to even up the season series here tonight in Biloxi before Carolina hops on the bus after this one, returns back to Winston-Salem tomorrow, and then get ready to see the Danbury Hat-Tricks coming up next weekend, 7:35 and 6:05 puck drops on Friday and Saturday night at the Annex. Limited tickets are still available for the Commissioner Cup rematch from last season. First time Danbury comes to Winston-Salem since all the way back last May. We're at the first intermission here in Biloxi. 1-1 your score between Carolina and Mississippi. We're back with more on the first intermission report after this. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
Graybrook Technologies is located in downtown Winston-Salem near the Dash Stadium. We specialize in automation, integration, and motor control with our team of dedicated engineers, a UL industrial control panel shop, and our warehouse packed with VFDs and components to fabricate the custom controls your company needs. Graybrook is a preferred partner with Danfoss, Siemens, Schneider Square D, and others to bring your project to life with brands you know and trust. Visit our website at graybrook.com or call us at 336-310-9092 to learn more about the array of services we offer.
Let's go Birds!
Flow Cadillac is a proud sponsor of the Carolina Thunderbirds. Visit 1400 South Stratford Road for a free test drive, or go online to flowcadillac.com to schedule a sales or service appointment.
Hey there, Triad Thunderbirds fans. Introducing Tee It Up Indoors, your ultimate golfing destination in Greensboro. With our cutting-edge golf simulators, you can tee off on world-class courses, no matter the weather. We're not just a golf facility. We're your partner in having a fantastic time. From golf lessons to corporate events, we've got it all covered. Plus, we even host birthday parties. Tee It Up Indoors, where golf meets excitement. Contact us today and swing into action.
Finish strong. Start here. Atrium Health Wake Forest Baptist.
Back here in Biloxi. 1-1 your score here at the first intermission at the Mississippi Coast Coliseum. Brendan Riley with you here on Thunderbirds TV and on WTOB. About 18 and a half minutes remain until the start of the second period as this Mardi Gras parade continues down on the ice here at the Mississippi Coast Coliseum. After a very fun first 20 minutes of action, did see four penalties in that first period. He saw three against Mississippi Carolina, though 0-for-3 on the power play after their one goal last night came on the power play. The one penalty against Carolina was an interference call against Curtis Heggie back at the 5:47 mark of that first period. Carolina killed it off now, 5-for-7 here this season. Here in this stretch here against Mississippi, or Mississippi now 5-for-7 on that power play here across these three-plus games. If you're with us last night on Thunderbirds TV and on WTOB, earlier this week, Carolina held their first week of a program, a learn-to-play program, in partnership with the Winston-Salem Police Department and the Salvation Army of Winston-Salem. Last night, we were having some technical difficulties during the first intermission. Weren't able to give it its proper time and talk for this great program that the Thunderbirds have just started. So if you're with us last night, you're going to see it again. Apologies for that. But here is another look at a deeper dive as to this new project, this new Learn to Play program that Carolina has, that the Thunderbirds have with the greater Winston-Salem area in conjunction with the Winston-Salem Police Department and the Salvation Army. Let's take a watch and a listen.
On Tuesday, the Thunderbirds held their first week of the Thunderbirds Learn to Play with the Salvation Army of Winston-Salem and the Winston-Salem Police Department.
Let me see. Let's pull it out.
In this program, the Thunderbirds are teaching children how to play hockey and helping them discover the game. This program is set to take place over the coming weeks, with Tuesday being the introduction. But some seem like they're already naturals on the ice. These kids, when they arrived, were fitted for skates and other equipment that the Thunderbirds will be purchasing for them so they can have every opportunity to play hockey.
We're part of the community here. Like, this isn't I always say, Kerry Ross or Barry Soskin team. This is a Winston-Salem hockey team, and we're trying to buy into the community and get involved with it, with all different types of groups. And we hope the community buys into us. And as I said, we're part of this city, and that's how we want to do it and portray ourselves. And the guys love coming out and helping young kids and all different facets of either playing hockey like this today, this program, or different, we go to schools or whatever. And as I said, we want to be part of this community, and we don't want to be on the outskirts. We want to be right in it.
I think this opens up a bunch of different things for this community. I think it's going to be great. Like I said earlier, hockey's not like an average sport everyone plays. So getting these kids on the ice is everything. You know, just opening their eyes to getting on the ice and skating is just a whole different ball game. And I'm happy that we're doing this, and I'm happy we're going to move forward with it. You know, seeing it from where I'm at now is awesome. You know, I know some of these kids at first probably, they don't like how tight the skates are. They don't like how it feels, but eventually they fall in love with it because they eventually get used to skating, and they start buzzing around the ice here, and they love it. And that just brings me pure joy. And can't ask for anything more.
A great initiative and a great program that the Thunderbirds have started here this week. Big credit to everyone that was involved in getting this program up and running here for this Thunderbirds team. You just heard from John Batita that, you know, hockey is that infectious game. Once you get out there, you get on the ice, you can really start to see why it's such a great game and why so many people have fallen in love with it here across the course of their fandoms. And so it's great to see the Thunderbirds starting that now and starting that program. And we'll continue throughout the weeks. We can give you updates as how the program continues to go along. What a great initiative and a great program started by the Thunderbirds and by this organization. Right now, here at the first intermission, still about 14 minutes until the start of the second period. This parade has finally stopped, and so now the Zamboni's getting out there. But a great program and a great thing that the Thunderbirds are doing, as they are going to be able to get all those kids, be able to get them brand new or new equipment, and get them equipment with all equipment being purchased by the Thunderbirds. We're at the first intermission, 1-1 your score between Carolina and Mississippi, about 13 and a half minutes until the start of period number two. I'll take a timeout here at the Mississippi Coast Coliseum. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
When it comes to performance, speed matters, just like on the ice. Introducing same-day dental crowns right here at Twin Oaks Dentistry. With cutting-edge technology, we craft crowns on-site, eliminating the need for temporary. As proud sponsors of the Carolina Thunderbirds, we understand the need for top-notch performance. We're more than just dental care. We're your partners in achieving your best smile. Twin Oaks Dentistry, where technology.
Mabel Chase Golf and Country Club offers the best in recreational amenities in the Triad.
Come enjoy a meal at the Pine Brook Bar and Grill, relax by our pool and cabana, and gear up at the Pro Shop while sharpening your skills on our 9,000 square foot putting green, and play around on our 18-hole Ellis Maples Design Championship Golf Course. You can find out more at MapleChaseCC.com. That's MapleChaseCC.com.
What's up, everybody? My name is Zach Taylor, and I'm the owner of Little Donuts. We're a mini donut food truck company specializing in apple cider mini donuts, traveling all over setting up at different events. This year, I'm happy to announce that we are a proud partner of the Carolina Thunderbirds, and we're going to be set up inside the Annex building all season long at every home game. So while you're out supporting your favorite hockey team, Swing by and warm up with some hot, fresh apple cider mini donuts made on site right when you order. Thank you. Hope you have a great day, and go Birds.
The Flow Garage app helps you keep up with your vehicles from anywhere. Flow customers can request service appointments, receive text and video updates, view sales and service history, receive recall notifications, and even get purchase offers via Flow Offer to Purchase. Download the app today.
We're back here in Biloxi, Carolina. And Mississippi tied up at one here at the first intermission. Brendan Riley with you here on Thunderbirds TV and on WTOB in this extended first intermission report here on a Friday night in Mississippi. It's time to take a look around the rest of the FPHL this evening. There was one other game in action last night, and that was between Port Huron and Elmira, and they're back at it again here this evening. It's the Prowlers who currently sit in the Continental Division. They sit 11 points back of the Thunderbirds, also 2 points ahead of the Mississippi Seawolves team. With just about 4 minutes gone in the third period, it is Port Huron with a 4-1 lead over Elmira. Mitch Jones opened the scoring just 16 seconds into that one there in Elmira. It'll be tied up at the 5:59 mark of the first period by Brent Parker before Port Huron has rattled off three unanswered goals. Sam Merritt gave them a 2-1 lead in the first period on the shorthand before a scoreless second, but Port Huron quickly here in the third period. Alex Johnson and Evan Foley have found the back of the net, and it's the Port Huron Prowlers with a 4-1 lead over the Elmira River Sharks. There's Port Huron. They try to take 6 points against the River Sharks. Looking elsewhere in the FPHL, we go to the Columbus Civic Center. Baton Rouge in Columbus battling right now in Columbus. They're about 17 minutes into the second period there in that one. Cody Wickline gave Columbus the 1-0 lead in the first. They would take that lead into the first intermission for Kyle Moore at the 9:32 mark in the second. Doubled the lead for Columbus, giving them a 2-0 lead. And then Noah Robinson was able to cut the lead in half just about 3 minutes later. He made it a 2-1 game, and that is where they sit right now with just under 3 minutes remaining in the second period. Columbus a 2-1 lead over Baton Rouge there in Columbus. Binghamton and Watertown battling at the Watertown Arena in Watertown, New York. A quick start for both sides, especially for Binghamton. Tyson Kirkby, 49 seconds in, gave the Black Bears the 1-0 lead. And then just over the midway mark of that first period on the power play, Watertown was able to tie it up, make it a 1-1 game before just over a minute later, Jesse Anderson regained the lead for Binghamton, who took a 2-1 lead. They took that into the dressing rooms and into the first intermission. In the second, Connor Smith made it a 2-goal game at that 3:57 mark in that second period on the power play, able to give Binghamton a 3-1 lead. That's where they sit with about 7.5 minutes to go there in the second period. Binghamton out shooting Watertown 27-13 there in that one. So Binghamton in front 3-1 in the final game here this evening from the Big Boy Arena in Fraser, Michigan. Motor City and Blue Ridge, they have a 3-3 this weekend. And it got off to a start for Motor City. They got the first two on the board. Scott Koach for the 14-60 mark of that first period. They made it, that made it a 1-0 game in favor of the home side. And then in the second, goals coming pretty quickly over the final 4 minutes. Jonathan Giuliano doubled the lead for Motor City, made it 2-0 at the 16:47 mark before Justin Daly found the back of the net. At the 18:05 mark, made it a 2-1 game. And then Declan Conway, just 10 seconds remaining there in the second period, made it 3-1 in favor of Motor City, who have the lead there. That's the look around the rest of the FPHL here this evening. Still about 7.5 minutes until the start of period number two. As the Zamboni continues to roll along out on the ice, a long time to sit and think for the two sides in the dressing room here in a 1-1 game. And how we got there, it was Jackson Bond giving Mississippi the 1-0 lead. Meter Banachik, just a few seconds later, tied us up at one. With assist from Dominic Dumas and Yuri Vastuka. Banachik continues to climb the leaderboards. He's first in the FPHL in assists with 38 here this season. He's now got points in now six of his last seven games. On the other side, Pastuca, he's now got his six assists here this season against Mississippi. He's up to 28 points. But Dominic Dumas, he is able to get his 13th assist. He's got 14 points for the Boise, Idaho native. Carolina leading this all-time series 13-3 here in Biloxi. They lead 4-2. Last year they went 12-1-1 against the Seawolves in their inaugural season. But last night the loss 5-1, the largest margin of defeat for Carolina here this year, currently sitting second in the Continental Division with 58 points. Showed the graphic earlier, and we'll bring it up again here as we have extra time here in this first intermission. And it is a tale of two seasons. You start off 16-3. It's your best start ever. You're first in the division back on December 23rd, coming off a 6-3 win against Columbus. You go into Christmas, and then the transaction started. Hey, guys get called up, guys leave. And since then, Carolina, 5-3 loss at Columbus, a 4-3 loss at home. The 5-4 win, back on New Year's Eve, that was able to get Carolina back in it. Then you get a 2-1 overtime victory. Josh Keplinger scoring both goals in that one and the overtime winner there on January 5th. Then you get the 9-5 victory in that win against Port Huron on that Saturday. So you go into that, you got three wins, but you only take 8 points in those wins with the overtime victory. And then you go into a shootout with Blue Ridge on that Thursday. And then you get the weekend off, and you come back, and the news of Dawson Baker and Gus Ford leaving. You go to Columbus, you lose 7-4. You come back home, you lose 2 straight for only the second time on the year. A 6-5 loss in the shootout to Mississippi last Friday. You bounce back with a 4-2 win, but then you drop last night, and you're 5-4-1 since December 23rd. And you take a look at the stats over that stretch. The Thunderbirds have given up 4.2 goals per game, the largest loss last night, but then 4 goals per game for the Thunderbirds over their last 10. But you take away that nine-goal game against Port Huron, you're really looking at about 3.5 goals per game after Carolina was roaring to start off this season. And you see the stats, especially the power play, not the power play necessarily, but the penalty kill has struggled. They're now 2-for-7 on the penalty kill against Mississippi over these 4 games. He allowed a shorthand goal last night, just inside 3 minutes into the game. And so Carolina, it's been an up and down, it's been a bumpy road over the last 10. But with all the turnover and all the new rosters, Steve Harrison is still trying to figure out how can they manufacture goals, how can they find something here, and how are they going to be able to get the lead and hang on to it across the next 40 minutes of action. 1-1 your score here at the first intermission, about 3:45 left until the start of the second period here on this 28-minute first intermission night. Second intermission, we'll be back to normal. We'll be back to a normal 18-minute intermission. But a fun night here in Biloxi so far. Fun first 20 minutes. Good crowd on hand. The fans doing the YMCA here at the Mississippi Coast Coliseum. We're closing in on puck drop for the start of the second period. And that's coming up on the other side of this timeout. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
Graybrook Technologies is located in downtown Winston-Salem near the Dash Stadium. We specialize in automation, integration, and motor control with our team of dedicated engineers, a UL industrial control panel shop, and our warehouse packed with VFDs and components to fabricate the custom controls your company needs. Graybrook is a preferred partner with Danfoss, Siemens, Schneider Square D, and others to bring your project to life with brands you know and trust. Visit our website at graybrook.com or call us at 336-310-9092 to learn more about the array of services we offer.
Let's go, Birds!
I want Hui to live a long, happy life. I give him supplements to take care of his joints. He's on preventatives to keep the fleas and ticks away. It's the same with my Subaru Outback. It takes care of us every day and when we go on adventures. We get our Outback serviced by the experts at Flo Subaru of Winston-Salem. I love my Subaru and I know it will live a long and happy life if I treat it right, just like Hui.
When it comes to performance, speed matters, just like on the ice. Introducing same-day dental crowns right here at Twin Oaks Dentistry. With cutting-edge technology, we craft crowns on-site, eliminating the need for temporary. As proud sponsors of the Carolina Thunderbirds, we understand the need for top-notch performance. We're more than just dental care. We're your partners in achieving your best smile. Twin Oaks Dentistry. We're taking.
Back here in Biloxi, Carolina, and Mississippi. Here after the first 20 minutes of action are tied up at one here at the Mississippi Coast Coliseum. Brendan Riley with you here on Thunderbirds TV and on WTOV. Great to have you along on your Friday evening. It should be an interesting 20 minutes. These two sides with a lot to think about. And that extended first intermission. We've made it to the second. We're tied up at one. Jackson Bond and Peter Banagic are the goal scorers. And that first 20 minutes of action, and now we are set for the start of period number two, which is brought to you by Flow Automotive. The shots on goal in our Comtech LLC shots on goal tracker. Carolina with 11, Mississippi with 13. Cody Karpinski has saved 12 out of 13. Blake Wyrick has saved 10 out of 11. We're start for the set of period number two, and it starts with Nate Keeley in for the draw against Yanni Liarakos. Carolina in their white sweaters, and Mississippi in their Mardi Gras sweaters here this evening. It starts with Cody Lynn, or rather Connor Lynn. He sends one in, comes back out to the point. Quick shot and a deflection goes high. Liarakos can get to it, and that one goes out of play. So quick start here for Mississippi. Quickly into the attacking zone. Brings up a faceoff to the right of Cody Karpinski. In his fourth game as a member of the Thunderbirds, faceoff is won back, and Karpinski gloves it and covers. Just about 17 seconds runoff here in this second period. Carolina trying to get out of their own defensive zone. Nate Keeley in for the draw. It's one back to the point. Hops over the stick of Lynn, and Horn chases after it. Horn taps it into the corner, trying to shovel it along. Nielsen steps in and starts out on the forehand. Across center ice, Nielsen up the far side, working one-on-one against Clay. Keeley circles the net, leaves it. Liarakos a shot and a save by Karpinski. There's some daylight on his near side. Liarakos center right into the middle of his pans as this one's dumped all the way down, and this goes for icing. Last night in the second period, it was Mississippi able to pull away. They took a 4-1 lead into the third period. Carolina got on the board in that second frame. John Batita on the power play. Long start here for this first shift in this third line to start things off. Jacob Schnapp touches it along, but it's taken in the neutral zone. Helen leaves it near side. Wong dumps it in as Nate Keeley sends him into the boards. A bouncing puck gets kicked behind the cage. Man loses his stick. That's Clay Keeley. It's loose in front. Wong trying to get a shot away. Instead, ran into his own man. Now Carolina going the other way. 3-on-2. Horn into the corner, trying to backhand one in through it behind Schnapp. It's banked back out. This one's going to come all the way in on Karpinski, who shovels it along to Justin Bione. 18:39 left to go here in period number two, and a stretch pass will race after it. Pastuca is able to get there first. Icing is waved off before Stoya shovels it along far side. Dumas stepping in, intercepts it. He gets sent into the boards, and it's bank tracked. The neutral zone is Dmitry Kuznetsov. Over to Lacio, trying to dance in. Got past Farmer. Here's a shot now and sails high from Kuznetsov and goes out of play. That's Good hustle from Yuri Pastuka. Won't quickly go on the other way. Carolina almost caught sleeping. As they'll bring out fresh legs, they're going to have Jan Salak, Curtis Heggie, John Batita, Fabian Granquist, and Joe Kennedy. Salak wins the draw. You're with 18:06 left to go here in the second period. Fabian Granquist battling at the blue line. He clears the zone as Kennedy, he takes it back. 2 minutes gone here in the second period. Kennedy, he holds and brings it behind his own cage with Lacio pressuring. This will bring more booze down as Kennedy starts up the far side. His pass, Haggy floats it along. It almost was intercepted. Instead, it was a bouncing puck that's now played back in the defensive zone, sent all the way down. Kennedy chases after it as Kuznetsov closing. He lost it. Here's Kuznetsov, sends one in front, a shot, and that one's blocked by Kennedy as he gets back. Salak now with some speed. Here's Jan Salak spinning his way into the half board. It's his third game since returning after missing the better part of 2 weeks to begin January. Salak slides it to Batsita, and it's cleared. Salak sitting on 199 assists in his FBHL career as the icing is called. And also 98 goals. He's two away from becoming the second player ever in a Thunderbird sweater to record 100 regular season goals. The other only one, Gus Ford, who reached the 100 mark back on November 25th. Faceoff is won by Justin Barr. Quick stretch pass up the far side. A little too much on it. It's Clay Keeley. Banks a pass off of the boards in front of the penalty boxes. Here's Schnapp walking up the slot. Schnapp slides over. Nick Keeley, a shot save. Rebound pokes free. Barr picks it up. Has it on the back end. Tries to get it to Koch. Instead, it's dumped in. Cross corner by Justin Bione. 16:43 left to go here in the second period. Shots are 16-12 in favor of Mississippi. Under Comtech LLC, shots on goal tracker. Puck just bouncing around in the neutral zone. Either side getting good possession right now. Here's Koch, though, starting at the near side. Koch throws it out in front. Here's a chance. Nielsen got a stick lifted by Schnapp. Good play there on the back check by the Tampa native. A stretch pass. A little too much on it for Banachik. Carolina in the midst of getting their first line out there. Stuka just off of the bench deflects that pass. Joe Kennedy throws one almost into the linesman's skates. Said it banks hard, and it goes for icing, and WTOB needs 10 seconds for station identification. We'll do that right now. This is Thunderbirds Hockey. So 16:04 remains here in the second period. Carolina, Mississippi tied at one. Jackson Bond and Peter Banachik, the goal scorers here in this one so far. Yuri Pastuka wins the draw off of the icing. Clay Keeley flutters it along, hops over the stick of Dumas, who chases after it, pins a man up against the boards in front of the benches. Lucas Helen turns around, zips one near side. Joe Kennedy gets the loose puck, gives it to his D partner. Clay Keeley, Banachik up to Pastuka, thought about a slap shot, he spins away, he walks the blue line, goal in three of his last four, backhands it over to far side, here's a shot, goes off of the glove of Weirich, back out to the point, Kennedy can't keep it in, it comes all the way back out to the neutral zone. Justin Movalli on the ice, haven't seen much of him across that first period, and his pass goes behind Dumas, and it will go for another icing. So 15:21 to go here in the second period, which is brought to you by Flow Automotive. It's another icing and another defensive zone faceoff to the right of Cody Karpinski. Karpinski 15-16 save across the first almost 25 minutes. Pastuka wins the draw. Mina Manachik not taking draws here this evening. Kuznetsov in the corner, slides it back out to the point. Turner walking the blue line, sends one in. It's sticked away by Karpinski, bounces back out in front. Movalli reaches out the right arm and just knocks it along as Dumas tries to chase after it. Kyle Russell, though, takes it, slides it to Kuznetsov, who's been all over the ice here across the first 5-plus minutes here in this second. Lacio dumps it in, cross corner. Joe Kennedy takes it. He had a man closing. Pokes it along. Pestuco waits. Gets it up to Salak. As now Salak chases after it. Getting a touch is Kyle Russell. It goes into the corner. Turner shovels it back out. Kuznetsov, his pass intercepted by Batita here. Salak, a shot. And it's deflected high off of the glass. Salak on the back end. Angled off by Sam Turner. Batita trying to get to the loose puck. It's thrown into the midsection of Kyle Russell. And it's still stuck at the half boards. 14-10 to go here in the second. They continue to whack at it. A good hit by James Farmer, but the hand goes up. This is going to be a delayed call. Lacio and Bione battling, and it looks like Carolina is going to be going to the penalty kill. When we come back, 13:58 remains here in the second period. It looks like James Farmer is going to be going off. And we have to run into a timeout. Tied at one here in Biloxi. And we're back to the Mississippi Coast Coliseum after this. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
Here at ComTech, we think it shouldn't cost a fortune to have peace of mind. That's why we bring you the latest in smart home protection and home monitoring at prices you can afford. Already paying for home monitoring? We can beat it. Give us a call today or visit us at ctpower.com. That's ctpower.com. ComTech, your one stop for security, fire, cameras, and more.
Mississippi, they're tied at one, and Carolina is going to be going on the penalty kill.
I think the entire Coliseum can get behind you when you say.
There were 13:58 to go here in this Flow Automotive second period. James Farmer called for an interference, and it brings out this Mississippi power play that is 5-for-7 here across 3-plus games against the Thunderbirds team. Tonight, though, they're 0-for-1. And the faceoff gets his back underway in the defensive zone. Nate Keeley slides it to Joe Kennedy and dumps it all the way down to start off this penalty kill. Carolina at 73% coming into this evening. Second to last in the FPHL. Port Huron, the only team with a lower mark, just south of 70%. Liorakos run off at the half boards by Nate Keeley. Puck bouncing around. It's back out to the point. Turner, Liorakos over to the top of the slot, and a one-timer from Wong's deflected out of play. It's power play for Mississippi. They like to try to get it to Liorakos, setting up over at the far dot, the lefty. Almost kind of like how the Washington Capitals always like Alexander Ovechkin to be set up at the dot. That's what they want Liorakos to do. He has it now, though. Sends it far side at the top of the zone. Turner, Nate Keeley on him. Makes a pass. Here's Liorakos. Pass a little too far in on him. Couldn't get the shot away. Turner still looking that way. Slide Liorakos, a shot, and that one sails wide. Not sure Karpinski saw it. Stoya at the blue line. Leaves it for Liorakos. He waits. His pass goes off the skate. Second attempt gets over to Stoya. Schnapp. A poke check. Puck goes high off of the glass and is dumped down by Nate Keeley. Here with 53 seconds remaining on the penalty kill for Carolina. James Farmer off for 2 minutes for interference. Batita, nice job being able to hold it up for a second. Salak almost throws Stoya as this one's wrapped in on the near side. It's left. Liorakos sends it across the blue line. Stoya winds and fires that one off a man in front and deflects into the near half boards. Batita with some space. They'll send it far side, and Salak will chase after it. He throws one in, the backhand's there. Batita, the rebound attempt, and it went through the crease. Carolina almost with the shorthanded goal right there. Not sure how Salak got that one on net, but the rebound was pretty juicy as Stoya shots gloved by Karpinski. And he covers with 12:10 to go here in the second and 13 to go on the James Farmer 2 minute call. But Salak somehow got it in Weirich able to blocker it away. Batita, he had to control the puck. It was bouncing. And he sent it through the crease and went just wide. We remained tied at one. Faceoff to the right of Karpinski. To the half boards. Nate Keeley trying to take it away, and he does. And he'll dump this one down here with 6 seconds left to go on the main advantage for Mississippi. Farmer out of the box. Back to 5-on-5. Carolina 2-for-2 on the penalty kill here tonight. But up the near side, here's Wong. Centering pass. It goes into the skates of Justin Bione. Dances away past a man and slides it up to Farmer. Just out of the box. James Farmer, top of the slot. His shot is saved by Weirich, who freezes with 11:42 to go here in the Flow Automotive second period. Here at home this season, Mississippi 10-7-0. Carolina on the road at 8-5-0 mark. And at home, they've been very good. Face-off in the attacking zones, won by Pastuca. Out to the point, Kennedy, a quick shot, save. Rebound comes loose in the slot. A backhand from Dumas goes off of Pastuca, and Mississippi starts the other way. 11.5 to go here in the second period into the corner. Clay Keeley pinned up against the boards by Kuznetsov. Lacio tried to shovel it along. Instead, Pastuca backhands it. It just clears the zone after it went high off of a stanchion. And Cody Karpinski leaves it for Joe Kennedy behind his own cage. 1-1, Jackson Bond and Vita Menacek, the goal scorers here tonight. Coming just 9 seconds apart. Menacek's pass, did Pastuca get a touch? No, he did not, and it goes for icing. So now multiple icings here in this second period, in this period of the long change. Start to add up across the stretch of a game. So we'll have Pastuca out there for the draw against Liorakos. Face off. He's poked free back to the point. Stoya, he holds, throws one off of the midsection of Koch, who picks it up. Koch near side, trying to dance in, throws it off the side of the cage. They whack at it. Karpinski holds strong. Dumas battling at the near half boards against Russell. It pokes free. Stoya, Vanacek closing, throws it up to Liorakos, who whiffs, but still gets it in far side. Karpinski out of his crease, thought about playing it, instead left it to Joe Kennedy. Into the attacking zone come the Thunderbirds. Vanacek over to Pastuca, just flutters one to far side. Kennedy was finishing off his run. It's now Kyle Russell. Across the blue line. Drops it to Liorakos. Back hands it over off of the boards. Salak stepping up. Knocks it along. Gets it right back. He's got James Farmer behind the net, and he leaves it for him. Here's, we've reached the midway mark here in period number two. Carolina and Mississippi tied up at one. Salak in the near corner. Spins away from a defender, backhands over to Granquist, throws it in front. Petita, he has it. He'll cycle it around. Granquist angles off a man. Salak, he forgot it though. In the corner now, Granquist battling against Stoya. Puck kicked around, it's gloved down and held in by Curtis Hege, who dumps it into vacant space. Liorakos though, trying to go the other way. Granquist applies a good hit on Lucas Helen. As now Hege slides it over far side to Farmer. 9:20 to go here in the second period. Farmer dumps it in. Weirich, trouble controlling it. Farmer wins the foot race. Pure hustle play there by James Farmer. Salak sent into the board, stays on his feet as they continue to battle. Farmer tangled up with Lind behind the play as Mississippi dumps it in. Karpinski knocks it down. Rims it off of the boards. At the blue line, Wong. Against Salak, just backhands it in. We're under 9 to go here in the second period. Carolina, Mississippi tied at 1. In the neutral zone. Lacio slides it far side to Sam Turner, trying to find a stretch pass, sends it right back to him. Lacio at the far side, the lefty, a shot saved by Karpinski. Rebound in the corner. Anderson joining the fray. Picking it up though, Kuznetsov walks into the slot, a shot saved, rebound Pumps free on the far side. Karpinski able to stand tall. Nate Keeley now drops it for Zach Horn. Horn, a shot blockered away by Weirich. And it's clear. Much different last night. Carolina, 47 shots last night. Right now, here with just about 8 minutes to go here in the second, they only have 16. A pass too much on it. Schnapp couldn't get a touch, and it goes for icing. And that brings us to another media timeout. 8 minutes exactly remain here in the second period. Carolina and Mississippi still knotted up at one here in Biloxi. We're back after this. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
Finish strong. Start here. Atrium Health Wake Forest Baptist.
Back here in Biloxi, Carolina and Mississippi tied up at one, and a good one right now. Shots on goal in our Comtech LLC. Shots on goal tracker are 20-16 in favor of Mississippi. Brenda Riley with you here on Thunderbirds TV and on WTOB Carolina. Trying to pick up a victory, and a victory in regulation here tonight. It will go a long way for this Thunderbirds team, building momentum before they face off against the Danbury Hattricks coming up next weekend. Danbury, they are off tonight. Currently 16-12-2 with 44 points here across the season. As now they're showing the kiss cam here in Biloxi. It looks like they have, looks like Schnapp and Horn. Now they show the other side. But 8 minutes to go here in this second period. Coming off another icing. There's been several for this Thunderbirds team. And they have another defensive zone faceoff. Comes to the right of Cody Karpinski, who's been good tonight. 19 of 20 shots that he's saved. We're back underway here in the second period, which is brought to you by Flow Automotive. Rattles over far side. Quick backhand touch, not enough on it. Schnapp ships it out of the zone. Zach Horn chases after Matt Stoya, who pitches one back out to the neutral zone. Quick touch pass. Liorakos drops the top of the slot. A shot. That one goes wide. A big hit there by Nate Keeley on Nielsen. The rebound is denied by Karpinski, but Nate Keeley, a massive hit there in the middle of the zone. 7:24 to go here in the second period. Horn dumps this one in off of the boards. Carolina gets on for a change. Weirich leaves it, a pass goes errant. Liorakos can't get a pass. Joe Kennedy. As we approach 7 to go here in the second period. Koch lost it at the top of the zone. Dumped in far corner. Liorakos and Pastuca. They battle. Liorakos rattles it over near point. Joe Kennedy gets there, sends it to Dominic Dumas. Dumas backhands it to Pastuca with under 7 to go here in the second. Kennedy holds it in at the point, just sends one in. It's kicked away. Banachik stepping in. Able to keep it in for a second before Stoya flips it out. It's gloved down. Liorakos at diving pass, and it goes straight into the waiting glove of Cody Karpinski. So 6:36 remains. They're in the Flow Automotive second period.
Section 22, I see you.
Carolina, Mississippi tied up at one. Face off. Jan Salak wins it. James Farmer backhands it to Justin Vioni. His pass, it's at the John Petito, leaves it in the neutral zone. It's dumped back in by Connor Lind.
Yoni trying to find Greenquist over on the far side. Too much on that pass here with 6:20 to go here in the second period. Stumpton rattles around. Karpinski had to go through his legs. And goes down on the far side as a bouncing puck comes in on Karpinski. He gloved it, does not freeze though as he drops it off to Farmer as we approach 6 to go here in the second. Farmer dances away from a hit from Wong. Plays it into the skates of Granquist, who banks one up the far side to John Petita. Petita one-on-one, dances in the slot. Petita can't get a shot away. Petita finished off a hit though on Lynn. Salak leaves it for Granquist. Tangled up with Jackson Bond. Jan Salak. Going one on two at the half boards. So you got Wong in there. Granquist joining the fray. It's poked back out to the point. Bione just trying to get a shot away. A deflection by Batita is gloved and held on to by Wyrick. There were 5:31 to go in the second. Good crowd on hand here on a Friday night. Much nicer today here in Biloxi. Thunderbirds got to town yesterday. Pouring rain. Wind. A lot of thunder and a face-off win for the Thunderbirds, but it goes through the skates of Mo Valley, chasing back after it with Lacio. He pokes it along. Here's a chance. A shot saved by Karpinski, and he swats away the rebound. Good luck there for Dmitry Kuznetsov. Karpinski squares it up, though. It's held in at the point and dumped in near side as we approach 5 minutes to go here in the second. Clay Keeley plays it off of the glass, and it's taken. Tyson Lambert goes far side, a pass too much on it. Will this go for icing? And it will here with 4:57 left to go here in the second period. So Carolina, they will have an attacking zone faceoff when we come back. 4:57 to go here in the second period. Carolina and Mississippi in a tight one right now, tied up at one. We're back to the Mississippi Coast Coliseum after this. This is Thunderbirds hockey.
Hey there, Triad Thunderbirds fans. Introducing Tee It Up Indoors, your ultimate golfing destination in Greensboro. With our cutting-edge golf simulators, you can tee off on world-class courses, no matter the weather. We're not just a golf facility. We're your partner in having a fantastic time. From golf lessons to corporate events, we've got it all covered. Plus, we even host birthday parties. Tee It Up Indoors, where golf meets excitement. Contact us today and swing into action.
Mississippi tied up at one with 4:56 left to go here in the second period. Carolina will have an attacking zone faceoff coming off of an icing committed by the Seawolves. This is the fourth straight matchup between the two sides. Carolina set to face off against Danbury coming up next weekend. Back at home at the Annex, 7:35 on Friday, 6:05 on Saturday. Which should be an interesting and tightly contested weekend. Carolina and Danbury. It's been a good one here so far tonight. Yuri Pastuka for the draw. Bounces around. Is brought back out to the neutral zone. Lambert tries to dump it in. Instead, Dalton Anderson takes it away. Vanacek a quick poke check. Near side, though. Spinning is Kuznetsov. His shot goes off of Dumas. Now it's a foot race. Dumas is going to get there. Here comes Dumas all alone. Dumas, a shot, goes tumbling into Wyrick. The net comes off its moorings as Dumas goes tumbling off behind the play. Dumas was in on the breakaway. Wyrick is down just to the right of his cage as Dumas and Lambert go colliding. Wyrick looks to be in some pain.
You got
well, but Dominic Dumas had the opportunity. It was a foot race. Dumas was able to win it, show off the speed. Lambert with Dumas trying to make a move to not get him over as now Wyrick comes back to his feet.
Thank you.
4 to go here in the second. Dominic Dumas has had chances here this weekend. On this line, Whitmanagic and Pastuca. Myrick, though, has had an answer. Whitmanagic lines up at the top of the circles. Pastuca for the draw. One out to the half boards. Curtis Hege, he'll take it. Whitmanagic taken down in the neutral zone. He's looking for a call. He's not going to get it. Kennedy, his pass deflected in by Dumas and in the corner. Pastuca takes it away from Stoya. Pastuca showing off the strength, sends it back out of the blue line. Hege just keeps it in, dumps it in near corner. Pass floated back out to the neutral zone. Kennedy intercepts, slides it to Dumas. He had to wait for Pastuca to get back onside. He gets taken down at the near half boards by Sam Turner. He's back to his feet, but Stoya glides out on the far side, a stretch pass to Koch into the attacking zone. Here's Liorakos, a centering pass, and they score. An unlucky bounce there for Curtis Hege. He got an initial poke check, went straight off of his skates to Yanni Liorakos. No one on the backside for Carolina. Centers one to Hugo Koch. Koch gets his 23rd goal of the season, while Liorakos gets his 32nd assist. And with 3:48 to go here in the second period, Mississippi regains the lead. It's 2-1. We're back underway. Carolina now chasing a goal once again. They got one 9 seconds after the first goal from Mississippi. Not getting it here off the near side. They dance in and they score. It's Jackson Bond for the second time here tonight and the third time this weekend. He doubles the lead for the Seawolves, and it's 3-1. Just 12 seconds after the goal from Hugo Koch, the goal from Jackson Bond, as the Seawolves ahead 3-1. And now Carolina with work to do with under 3.5 minutes to go here in the second period. Carolina in danger of being swept for the first time all season in a series. A big hit Nate Keeley takes from Wong. Stayed on his feet though, behind the net. Oaks free on the near side. Carolina trying to get one here before the two sides go to the dressing rooms. Kennedy plays a bank pass out to Jacob Schnock. Drops it for Zach Horn, trying to shovel it along. Horn shoved into the glass. Near side with 2:50 to go here in the second. Dumped all the way down. Blake Keeley will pick it up. Both sides get off for a change. Stretch pass, Horn trying to dance past Lambert into the corner. Just throws one in. A Wyrick rebound comes free on the far side. Pastuca couldn't settle it down. The blue line, Anderson, he waits. Throws it into the middle. Takes it right back. Anderson trying to get past Farmer. Farmer angles him to the corner. Puck bounces free. His net's off. And Spinacic with Farmer closing in on him. He's thrown back out in front. No one is home, though. Dangerous pass there. Pastuca throws it into the skates of Dmitry Kuznetsov. 120 seconds to go here in the second period. Carolina trailing 3-1. And this goes all the way down for icing. Carolina will have the attacking zone faceoff, but goals coming just 12 seconds apart. Hugo Koch with assists from Joaquin Nielsen, and Yanni Liorakos made it 2-1 at the 16-12 mark, and then Jackson Bond from Philip Wong for the second time tonight. 12 seconds later.
What do you think about your Seawolves?
Now they're going to bring the faceoff back to center ice.
Yeah.
It's 1-0 by Justin Barr. And to reset the clock, so now a minute 48 remains here in the second. Joe Kennedy throws it right to Batita, who now has a chance. Batita up the near side, slides it to Granquist on the backhand. His shot goes off the side of the cage. Batita takes a back throw in front. Nate Keeley's shot goes high. Good luck there for Nate Keeley. It's been one of those weekends for this Thunderbirds team. It's rattled in. Keeley hit by two. It's sent along. Granquist looking for options. Drops it to Kennedy. Kennedy dancing in front of backhand. Saved by Weirich as he sits down and he makes the save here with 1:13 to go in the second. So 73 seconds remain here in the Flow Automotive second period. 3-1 your score in favor of Mississippi. Menachik at the top of the dots. The faceoff is won, though, by Jackson Bond. Two guys go tangling over in the far side. Pastuca went down to the ground. You got the check line back together with Jan Salak out there with Menachik and Pastuca. Pastuca to Menachik. He's waiting his shot. Blockered away. It's high in the air in front, and it's cleared. Weirich making another big save. And it's been the storyline here this weekend. A bank pass. Menachik has it poked away by Soy. Clay Keeley loses an edge. Dangerous here for the Thunderbirds. James Farmer able to help out his defensive partner. Salat goes cross ice. Pastuca has to wait and dump it in. 27 seconds to go here in the second period. It's poked free. Salat to Menachik. Slides it over Bioni. It's behind him. He can't find it. Liarakos pokes it away here with 17 seconds. He lost his stick, though. Kicks it in front. Karpinski just able to shove along. Here's a shot, though, and a save by Karpinski. Liarakos still doesn't have a stick. Bioni tackles him to the ground. He's kicking, trying to move it away, and it comes to Kennedy, who will bring it behind, and he'll settle things down, and the Thunderbirds head to the second intermission, trailing by two. Liarakos doesn't lose his stick there. It could very easily be a 4-1 game. But the middle 20 have come and gone here in Biloxi. Carolina trailed 4-1 heading to the third last night. Here tonight, they trailed the Mississippi Seawolves by a score of 3-1 after the first 40 minutes. We've reached the second intermission. Carolina work to do across the final 20. Can they find a comeback here in Biloxi? We'll have to find out. We're back with the Little Italy second intermission report after this. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
For over 85 years, Mustin and Crutchfield has been more than just a local market. We've been a proud part of North Carolina's heritage. When our founders started in 1938, they sourced meats from local farmers and groceries from small companies. Finding a way to stay competitive in this market has been a challenge through the years. Luckily, there are a lot of entrepreneurs, and now we have close to 50 local vendors that we feature. We're proud to partner with the Carolina Thunderbirds as a local sponsor, celebrating community values both on and off the ice. Mustin and Crutchfield, your hometown local grocer.
Hi, I'm Stuart with Fiddlin' Fish Brewing Company here in Winston-Salem, North Carolina. I've been proud to be the official craft beer of Carolina Thunderbirds since 2018. Be sure to find us on draft or in cans at the games or come down and see us. We're here in downtown Winston-Salem. Go Birds.
Hey there, Triad Thunderbirds fans. Introducing Tee It Up Indoors, your ultimate golfing destination in Greensboro. With our cutting-edge golf simulators, you can tee off on world-class courses, no matter the weather. We're not just a golf facility. We're your partner in having a fantastic time. From golf lessons to corporate events, we've got it all covered. Plus, we even host birthday parties. Tee It Up Indoors, where golf meets excitement. Contact us today and swing into action.
I want Hui to live a long, happy life. I give him supplements to take care of his joints. He's on preventatives to keep the fleas and ticks away. It's the same with my Subaru Outback. He takes care of us every day and when we go on adventures. We get our Outback serviced by the experts at Flo Subaru of Winston-Salem. I love my Subaru, and I know it will live a long and happy life if I treat it right, just like Huey.
Here in Biloxi, Carolina trails 3-1 after the first 40 minutes of action here for the Mississippi Coast Coliseum as we've reached the Little Italy second intermission report. Brenda Riley with you here on Thunderbirds TV and on WTOV. And a second period that just in a matter of seconds saw Mississippi take a 2-goal lead. Both sides battling across the first 15-plus minutes in that first period before an unlucky break for Carolina. Curtis Hagee delivered a good poke check, but it went right off of the skates. Yanni Liarakos, who was able to float one across the zone to Hugo Koch, who was all alone for a tip-in goal to make it 2-1. And then 12 seconds later, Jackson Bond from Philip Wong made it 3-1 in favor of the Seawolves. Bond pretty much off of the restart, taking it from his own zone. Dance right out in front of Cody Karpinski, and made it a 3-1 game. And that is where we stand right now after the first 40 minutes of action. The shots on goal in our Comtech LLC shots on goal tracker. 24-19 in favor of Mississippi. Blake Weirich has saved 23 out of 24 shots on the other side. Rather, Cody Karpinski has saved 21 out of 24 shots on the other side. Blake Weirich, he has saved 18 out of 19. Last night, Carolina, 47 shots that Weirich made 46 saves on. In that second period, after we had four penalties across the first period, James Farmer was called for an interference. Nothing came of it, though. That was the only penalty we had in that second period. And now Carolina trailing 3-1. Trailed 4-1 last night. Last night, their largest differential of a loss last night with four after they lost 5-1 last night. Late empty netter there from Jackson Vaughn made it that. It was previously 3, which was against Columbus back last Wednesday down at the Columbus Civic Center. So right now, Carolina trying to find something here across the final 20 minutes of action. Other than that, this game has been pretty back and forth, but two quick goals is 12 seconds apart. Mississippi striking just like that. The Seawolves team is getting hot. Averaged over four goals per game despite having a goal differential at a minus 14. They've won four of their last five, trying to make it 5 out of their last 6. For Carolina, one more goal given up here tonight. That would be their 6th time in their last 7 games, allowing 4 or more goals here over this recent stretch. Carolina trying to figure things out on the back end here. As we get towards the end of January, coming up next week, and don't forget, it will be Carolina and Danbury, then Carolina won't play after that until the following Saturday on the 10th when they play at Blue Ridge. Then they have a Valentine's Day edition against Blue Ridge on that Wednesday. Then they're back here in Biloxi the following weekend. Carolina with a tough stretch coming up next weekend, though. The last time that they will see an opponent from the other division when they see Danbury next week. And other than that, though, it'll be the Continental Division the rest of the way. So if Carolina wants to get where they want to get to, they're going to have to beat their own divisional folks. Right now, we're at the second intermission, which is brought to you by Little Italy Pizza. Carolina trails 3-1 here against the Mississippi Seawolves. And we're back after this here on Thunderbirds TV and on WTOB. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
Here at Comtech, we think it shouldn't cost a fortune to have peace of mind. That's why we bring you the latest in smart home protection and home monitoring at prices you can afford. Already paying for home monitoring? We can beat it. Give us a call today or visit us at ctpower.com. That's ctpower.com. Comtech, your one stop for security, fire, cameras, and more.
Hey Thunderbirds, are you looking for a metal building?
Here at Bulldog Steel Structures, we got you covered with multiple garages, barns, and styles you need.
Contact us today to get your free quote at 888-551-2156.
or visit our website, www.bulldogsteelstructures.com, and mention the Thunderbirds, and we'll give you a flying deal. God bless you.
Go Thunderbirds!
Proud sponsor of the Carolina Thunderbirds, Parrish Tire and Automotive, your reliable, local, and honest choice. In Winston-Salem, Mount Airy, Dobson, Jonesville, and Clemens. Go Birds!
Finish strong. Start here. Atrium Health Wake Forest Baptist.
Back here in Biloxi, 3-1. The Mississippi Seawolves lead the Carolina Thunderbirds here on Mardi Gras night here at the Mississippi Coast Coliseum. Carolina in danger of dropping two in a row and being swept for the first time here this season. Time to update you on scores around the rest of the MPHL here this evening. Got a final from First Arena, Port Huron. They pick up a 5-1 victory. Three third period goals end up putting away the Elmira River Sharks as Port Huron pick up 6 points against Elmira. An improve here this season, now to 50 points on the year. They're now 16-12-4. Elmira drops that one. Binghamton and Watertown right now in a two-goal game at the midway mark of the third period. Watertown cutting the lead in half just 37 seconds into the third on Trevor Lord's goal, but since then neither side's been able to find anything. Binghamton out shooting Watertown 46-20. It's 4-2 there in that one. Also had a lot of penalties in that one as well. Dakota Seaman, he got a spearing match penalty there in that one. Binghamton leading 4-2 there. Columbus Civic Center. It's Columbus River Dragons, a 3-1 lead over the Baton Rouge Zydeco with about 3.5 minutes to go there in the third period. A goal in each period for the Columbus River Dragons. Kyle Moore's got two. Cody Wickline a goal as well. As Columbus, they have the lead there. And then the final game here this evening is from Big Boy Arena. They're about a minute into the third period there in Fraser, Michigan. It's the Motor City Rockers with a 4-1 lead over the Blue Ridge Bobcats. There in that one. So right now, Motor City, the 4-1 lead over Blue Ridge there at Big Boy Arena. But here at the Mississippi Coast Coliseum, Carolina in danger right now. They're trailing 3-1. After the first 40 minutes of action, trying to find a comeback over the final 20 minutes of action to avoid a loss in 4 out of 5. One of those, a shootout loss, but still, Carolina in trouble right now. Trying to find something here. You have to wonder what the head coach Steve Harrison is saying there in the dressing room to his team. Trying to find something. Blake Weirich has saved 18 out of 19 shots. Cody Karpinski saved 21 out of 24. We reset things for the start of the third period after this. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
Hey there, Triad Thunderbirds fans. Introducing Tee It Up Indoors, your ultimate golfing destination in Greensboro. With our cutting-edge golf simulators, you can tee off on world-class courses, no matter the weather. We're not just a golf facility. We're your partner in having a fantastic time. From golf lessons to corporate events, we've got it all covered. Plus, we even host birthday parties. Tee It Up Indoors, where golf meets excitement. Contact us today and swing into action.
Mabel Chase Golf and Country Club offers the best in recreational amenities in the Triad.
Come enjoy a meal at the Pine Brook Bar and Grill. Relax by our pool and cabana and gear up at the Pro Shop while sharpening your skills on our 9,000 square foot putting green and play around on our 18-hole Ellis Maples Design Championship Golf Course. You can find out more at MapleChaseCC.com. That's MapleChaseCC.com.
Scott Brandon with DS Brandon Plumbing. I have 30 years of plumbing experience in the Triad. DSBPCO at triad.rr.com. Proud supporter of the Thunderbirds. Go Birds.
Get ready, Winston-Salem. Jennifer Sapp, your trusted realtor and broker since 1997, puts the real in realtor, and she's proud to be a sponsor of your Carolina Thunderbirds. As a top producer and your go-to realtor for all your real estate needs, Jennifer Sapp is ready to help you score your dream home goals. Call Jennifer at 336-782-3148 or visit her at jennifersapp.allenton.com.
Your score here at the Little Italy second intermission report. Brendan Riley with you here on Thunderbirds TV and on WTOB. Carolina trailing after the first 40 minutes here at the Mississippi Coast Coliseum, in danger of dropping, being swept in a series for the first time this year. Time to update you on the franchise leader when it comes to points and assists here throughout the history of the Thunderbirds. You take a look here. Jan Salat, currently the franchise leader with 260. These numbers coming into today's matchup. See Gus Ford with 245. Peter Banacek with his goal here tonight, now up to 244 here in his career. John Batita sitting at 201. There, he got his 200th point last weekend as a member of the Thunderbirds. And then Yuri Pastuca, 179 coming into today. He had an assist on that goal that made it a 1-1 game at the time. He's now got 180 here this year. The guy there on that list, Peter Banacek, he has been a catalyst for the Thunderbirds all year long. Team leader in points with 46 here this season. You take a look at the franchise leaders in assists as well. See, Banacek, he's in first there in the assist leaderboard with 38 of those coming this year. 167 assists for Peter Banacek, who is six away from tying his single-season career high. See Salak with 162, John Batita 137, Gus Ford 132, and Yuri Pastuca 106 coming in today, and now 107 for him. So those guys all filling up the leaderboards here for the Thunderbirds throughout the franchise history. And right now here at our second intermission, our Little Italy second intermission report, Carolina trails 3-1. They had 47 shots last night. They have 19 here tonight. They've only beaten Blake Wyrick twice across 100 minutes here this week. And on the other side, Cody Karpinski has given up 7 goals here this weekend. And now Karpinski is going to have to be great in the third. Carolina is going to have to find something here across the final 20 minutes of action here at the Mississippi Coast Coliseum. Coming in at 2 tonight, Carolina. Here in Biloxi, 4-2, all-time leading the all-time series between these two sides. Carolina in danger of dropping their 8th game in regulation here this season. Carolina, Mississippi to win multiple games against them for the first time ever. We're closing in on the start of period number 3. Carolina and Mississippi for the 4th and final time in a row. And there's 20 minutes left to go here from the Mississippi Coast Coliseum. The third period is coming up on the other side of this timeout. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
Hey, Thunderbirds, are you looking for a metal building?
Here at Bulldog Steel Structures, we got you covered with multiple garages, barns, and styles you need.
Contact us today to get your free quote at 888-551-2156.
Or visit our website, www.bulldogsteelstructures.com. And mention the Thunderbirds, and we'll give you a flying deal. God bless you.
Go Thunderbirds!
Go.
Graybrook Technologies is located in downtown Winston-Salem near the Dash Stadium. We specialize in automation, integration, and motor control with our team of dedicated engineers, a UL industrial control panel shop, and our warehouse packed with VFDs and components to fabricate the custom controls your company needs. Graybrook is a preferred partner with Danfoss, Siemens, Schneider Square D, and others, to bring your project to life with brands you know and trust. Visit our website at graybrook.com or call us at 336-310-9092 to learn more about the array of services we offer.
Let's go Birds!
Flo Cadillac is a proud sponsor of the Carolina Thunderbirds. Visit 1400 South Stratford Road for a free test drive, or go online to flowcadillac.com to schedule a sales or service appointment.
Hey there, Triad Thunderbirds fans. Introducing Tee It Up Indoors, your ultimate golfing destination in Greensboro. With our cutting-edge golf simulators, you can tee off on world-class courses, no matter the weather. We're not just a golf facility. We're your partner in having a fantastic time. From golf lessons to corporate events, we've got it all covered. Plus, we even host birthday parties. Tee It Up Indoors, where golf meets excitement. Contact us today and swing into action.
20 minutes remain here in Biloxi. Carolina trails the Mississippi Seawolves by a score of 3-1 after the first 40 minutes of action. Jackson Bond has a pair of goals here tonight for Mississippi. Hugo Koch, he found the back of the net. Peter Manetchik, he's got the lone goal for Carolina, with Philip Wong, a pair of assists. Joaquim Nielsen and Yanni Liarakos, they have assists as well. Dominic Dumas and Yuri Pistuka, they have the assists on the Peter Manetchik goal. We've reached the third period here in Biloxi, which is brought to you by Mustin and Crutchfield. Carolina in danger of dropping their fourth out of their last five and being swept for the first time here in 2023-2024. Brendan Riley with you here on Thunderbirds TV and on WTOB. Both teams back out on the ice, and we're ready to restart things here across the final 20 minutes of action. Last night, a 5-1 win for Mississippi. And now Carolina, who has two goals across 100 minutes, are going to have to find at least two here this evening if they want to come away with any sort of points. 24-19, Mississippi out shooting Carolina. Cody Karpinski. And Blake Wyrick in their respective nets. Nate Keeley, Jacob Schnapp, Zach Horn, Clay Keeley and Joe Kenny. It'll be Nate Keeley and Yanni Liarakos to restart things here in the Mustin and Crutchfield third period, and we're underway here in the final 20 minutes in Biloxi. Carolina needs a comeback, and they start with possession in their own defensive zone. Clay Keeley sends one down. It's tipped along. Here's Nate Keeley. A shot, safe, rebound. It's Zimp. Goes off the side of the cage. She gloves it down, has it on the backhand. He'll cycle it down to Zach Korn. Steps up to the corner. Dumps it behind the net. Liarakos shovels it along as he had Schnapp closing. He has it. He just lofts it down ice. Nielsen knocks it down on the far side. Joaquim Nielsen draws it back. Liarakos trying to touch one near side. Trying to get it to Koch, who now has it in the corner. Plays a bank pass. Liarakos throws it back out. Stoya, top of the zone, sends it near side. Koch, centering pass. The shot. And they score. Joaquim Nielsen was loose in the slot. Karpinski, he got most of it, but not all of it, as it trickles in. And just 44 seconds into the third period, Mississippi has taken a 4-1 lead. Back underway, Mississippi controls off the restart. Far side. Hustle. Makes a pass up, James Farmer. He collects, sends it to Justin Bione, and it's dumped in. Wyrick, he leaves it for Tyson Lambert. Sends it far side. Hugo Koch getting an assist, as well as Matt Stoya, Farmer at the red line. As it poked away, Kyle Russell, he has it on the forehand, has some space, throws one off of the skates of Lacio. Lacio backhands it, a good hit by Bione. Carolina trying to go the other way. Grandquist, he's looking for reinforcements. Carolina in the midst of a change. Grandquist in the corner, going one-on-one. Loses it, now they're gonna drop the gloves at center ice. Philip Wong and Justin Movalli right at the Seawolves logo. Couple of rights from Wong. Movalli trying to get a right in. Wong delivering rights. Movalli getting a few punches back in. They continue to go at it. Right at center ice, a right hook. Movalli tying up. There's a good clean hit. Wong comes back. Helmet's coming off of Movalli. Movalli goes down as Wong tackles him. Trying to spark something for his team. Wong wins it though. Valley wanted something, and now they're chatting over by the benches. Steve Harrison leaning over as now trainer goes over. John Batita over by the near side. How we feeling, section 18? Looks like there is some blood on the ice there. Movalli trying to find a spark. First time in four games that these two sides have dropped the gloves. Valley hadn't played much here tonight. Carolina's trying to find the spark. Valley back out onto the ice. He's going to go over to the far side. Valley goes to be attended to. Valley, the first time he's dropped the gloves as a member of a Thunderbird. But everything going Mississippi's way. But now will that spark something for this Thunderbirds team? Well, Valley just trying to find something and find energy for this Thunderbirds team. They've been outscored 9-2 here this weekend. Five remains here in the Munson and Crutchfield third period. Wong in the box. At 60 penalty minutes coming into tonight. Novalli now off the bench. Carolina with an attacking zone faceoff. Faceoffs won by Jan Solak. Granquist pokes it back to the blue line. Bione tries to keep it in. Barr on the far side sends one back in as they announce the 5-minute majors for fighting. A Bank pass goes high off of the glass. The far side, Bond dumps it in. He's working on two goals here tonight. Karpinski rattles it around near side. It's almost intercepted as Karpinski just gets back at the point. Sam Turner sends one far side. He was looking for a deflection. No one got it, though. Petita and Bond. Petita wins that one-on-one matchup, but gets a stick lifted. He's shaking his left hand. Thinks that he might have gotten slashed. Connor Lind spins in front of his own bench. Here with 17:43 to go in the third period. 4-1, Mississippi has the lead. Bione chips one along. And it's played back to Lind. Carolina trying to get some energy here. Trying to get one quickly to get back into this. They haven't been able to get into their own attacking zone, though. It's backhanded in by Helen. Kennedy puts the brakes on, sends it far side. Curtis Egge plays a bouncing puck, has it on the backhand. He dumps this one in as Carolina chases. Behind the net, Egge and Stoya. Stoya slides it to Nielsen, sends it far side. Here comes Koch. Koch dancing in front, tries to drop it back for Liarakos. Nice job by Kennedy, though, angling it off. Good touch as this one's going to come all the way back in on Weinrich. He chips one. Dumas got a touch. Horn was closing on Weinrich. Instead, Stoya walks right down Broad Street to the outside, trying to get it to Liarakos. He chases after it into the corner. Heggy was closing. Heggy now intercepts at the blue line. Heggy steps up and just flips it back out to the neutral zone. 16:27 to go here in the third period. Carolina trailing 4-1. Liarakos gloves it down, slid it to Nielsen, and gets it back. Liarakos between the legs. Pass, a shot. Karpinski shoulders it high off of the glass. Koch banks it along. Another behind between the legs attempt by Liarakos. It's sent back out to the point. Russell drives it to Koch, sends it far side. A shot, and that one didn't get, not getting all of it on it, was Nielsen. Good check by Dumas on Russell. On the far side, though, Liarakos in front. Backhands it back out to Lambert. Sends it near side. Russell into the corner. Koch can't control it. Heggie picks it up here with 15:47 left to go here in the third. Pastuka chips it over to Vanacek. Vanacek, a lone goal scorer here tonight. He leaves it for Pastuka. Spins away into the corner. Pastuka waits, and the puck slide off of his stick. A good touch. Lacio takes it away. Lacio up the far side. Hit shot. Saved by Karpinski. Trying to go blocker side. Karpinski got the shoulder there. Batita poked away. Here's a chance in front. Batita takes a man down. No call as Anderson went tumbling to the ground. Kuznetsov quickly back in, trying to find a lead pass. It's knocked down and in the near half boards. Granquist battling against Lacio. Kuznetsov rattles it over far side. No one home in a Mardi Gras sweater as Jan Salak tries to find a stretch pass. It's deflected. Granquist chases after it into the corner. Spins away from Sam Turner, but it's taken away before Batita battles for it. Here's Salak, sends it far side, and a good touch by Lacio with Kennedy crashing the net. Granquist leaves it. Batita and Lind, they battle. Salak picks it up, sends it back out to Joe Kennedy. Tries to get one out on net, didn't get a lot on it. So the puck continues to bounce around. And Turner, he holds. Slides it over to Lind with 14:25 left to go. Here in the third period, Carolina chasing three. Farmer hit by two Seawolves. So he goes down. A little extra there from Helen on Farmer as the 2-11s exchange blows. Seawolves get off for a change. We approach 6 minutes gone. Jackson Bond trying to dance in, trying to find a centering pass. Too much on it for Justin Barr. Bond trying to move it along. Farmer now battling in the corner. Bank hands it over far side. 13:50 remains. Head of steam and some space for Zach Korn, who sends one in. It's parried away and goes out of play by Weirich. And that brings up a stoppage here with 13:42 remaining in the third period. An early goal here in this third period comes from Joachim Nielsen. Then Justin Movalli and Philip Wong drop the gloves. Mississippi, they lead 4-1. And we're back after this. This is Thunderbird Hockey.
Get ready, Winston-Salem.
Jennifer Sapp, your trusted realtor and broker since 1997, puts the real in realtor, and she's proud to be a sponsor of your Carolina Thunderbirds. As a top producer and your go-to realtor for all your real estate needs, Jennifer Sapp is ready to help you score your dream home goal. Call Jennifer at 336-782-3148 or visit her at jennifersapp.allenton.com.
.42 remains here in the Mustang and Crutchfield third period. It's Mississippi with a 4-1 lead over the Carolina Thunderbirds here in this one. In this third period, Joaquin Nielsen with assists from Hugo Koch and Matt Stoya at the 44-second mark. Have the Seawolves in front. Justin Movalli and Philip Wong, 95 seconds into this third period. Drop the gloves with Movalli trying to find a spark for his team. Right now, it has been all Mississippi over the last 15-plus minutes. Shots are 26-20 on our Comtech LLC. Shots on goal tracker in Carolina. They can get one quickly. It can make things interesting. And they start with a face-off to the left of Blake Wyrick. Liarakos and Nate Keeley for the draw. They tangle up over at the far half court. It's Granquist in the fray battling against two Seawolves. Schnott pokes it away, has it on the back end. He spins, and the slot a shot, and a save by Wyrick. Rebound. Pokes free over on the far side. Liarakos. Pass up to Koch. Koch trying to float one to Nielsen. It's knocked down by Bione. Clay Keeley in the corner battling. Koch can't shovel it along. Granquist. Just signed yesterday. Yesterday's first game since all the way back on December 22nd. In a 5-0 shutout win for Carolina. He was on the other side for Blue Ridge. Clearing attempts, glove down, and now Carolina tries to break. Liarakos banks a pass to Nielsen in front of the Thunderbirds bench. Carolina in their white sweaters here tonight. Mississippi in their Mardi Gras uniforms. 12:45 remains in the third period. A stretch pass to Pastuka, trying to slide it to Salak. It's poked away, though, by Sam Turner. Kuznetsov tries to dump one in, goes off of Banachik. It's knocked down the near half boards. Anderson dances by Farmer, throws one out in front. Salak, last line of defense. Lacio is right there. If he's not there, it could be 5-1. Neutral zone, Pastuka, he gets it back to Banachik. It was a game-time decision tonight after he left in the second period last night. Kennedy banks a pass behind his own net to Peter Banachik, who surveys. His only option, Yuri Pastuka. Lofts one, trying to get it to Joe Kennedy. Sam Turner gets there first. He has it in the corner. Anderson, his pass goes off the skates of Banachik. On the far side, a stretch pass goes wanting. James Farmer, he collects with 11:45 remaining here in the third period in Biloxi. Carolina in danger of being swept for the first time here this season. Kennedy dumps it in and hops over the stick of Wyrick. Shoveled back by Kuznetsov. Lind sends it D to D on the far side. Petita stepping in, pokes it away. Zach Horn gets the loose puck. Horn chips it into the corner. Petita battling against Helen. Helen wins the battle. Slides it over to Turner. And it's fired back out to the neutral zone. Kuznetsov sends one in. That one goes wide to Karpinski. Stoya keeps it in at the blue line, but Mississippi goes off for a change with 11 minutes to go here in the third period at the Mississippi Coast Coliseum. The far side, here's Horn. A shot saved by Wyrick. Parries it behind the cage. Curtis Heggie can't keep it in. He's got Nielsen pressuring him. Gets rid of it quickly as he slides it over to Clay Keeley. He throws it off of Stoya. Horn pressuring, and on the near side, a quick bank pass to Nielsen. We got the goal just 44 seconds into this third period. Here's Horn looking. Horn waits, sends one in. Wyrick makes a save, but Tita sends it right back behind the net. Granquist and Horn, the two newest additions to this Thunderbirds roster. They battle for it. And it's sent back out to the neutral zone as we approach 10 minutes to go here in the third period. The Farmer in front of his own cage. Sends it to Vioni. Batita kicks it. Tries to get it up to Schnapp. But Carolina with just nothing getting into the attacking zone here tonight. That took a deflection. It's not going to be icing after it went off a stick of a Thunderbird in the neutral zone. Vioni loses it. Lacio sends it behind the net. Farmer takes it away as Granquist throws one off of the leg of Schnapp, who at the red line just rims one in. 9:43 to go here in the third period. Lacio walking up the near side, drops his nets off. Nate Keeley tapped it away, and Joe Kennedy walks into the neutral zone, slides it to Salak, dances to the outside, centering pass. Kennedy got tangled up in front. Him and Kyle Russell. Lacio quickly the other way, trying to send one across the zone. Anderson with one hand tried to knock it down, and it's poked back in. Mississippi has to get back onside, and with that, they go off for a change. 9:10 to go here in the third period. Carolina down by three. A hand goes up as Clay Keeley gets tripped, and Carolina's going to be going to a power play. 9:03 remains here in the third period. A trip is called as Wong comes out of the box. And it's going to be Nielsen going to the penalty box. 9:03 remains. Carolina's going to have a power play, and they need one desperately here on the other side of this timeout. They trail 4-1. Just over 9 to go here in Biloxi. Back after this, this is Thunderbirds Hockey.
I want Huey to live a long, happy life. I give him supplements to take care of his joints. He's on preventatives to keep the fleas and ticks away. It's the same with my Subaru Outback. He takes care of us every day. And when we go on adventures, we get our Outback serviced by the experts at Flo Subaru of Winston-Salem. I love my Subaru, and I know it will live a long and happy life if I treat it right, just like Huey.
Riddle Tractor has been selling and servicing tractors, mowers, and more for over 43 years. We stock over 50,000 parts, and we service what we sell. Visit us at RiddleTractor.com. That's RiddleTractor.com, equipping those who get the job done.
Quick hit. One of those words are misspelled.
Joachim Nielsen to the box at the 10:57 mark with a tripping call, as Carolina is going to go on a Little Italy power play with 9:03 left to go here in period number three. They trail the Mississippi Seawolves 4-1, as Carolina right now in danger of being swept for the first time here this season. Brendan Riley with you here on Thunderbirds TV. This game was tied at 1 in the first. Here's 2 goals quickly. Ended up making it a 3-1 game. Joachim Nielsen is now in the box. He's made it 4-1 just 44 seconds in. Carolina starting on this power play with this first unit. 0 for tonight for Carolina, as Liorakos takes it out of his own defensive zone, gets across the red line and flutters one in to the corner. Justin Barr circles behind the cage. 8.5 to go and 1:30 left to go on the power play. Carolina 0-3 on the power play here tonight. 8.5 to go. Jan Salak in the near half court. Salak holds it on the backhand. Goes wide to the outside, sends it back to Peter Bonacic and gets a return pass at the far half boards. Salak spins away from Stoya, back out to the point. Quick one-touch pass to Pastuca. Pastuca sends it right back to Bonacic. He's got the lone goal here tonight. He's got 8 this season. Here's a pass in the slot. Keeley can't control it. Liorakos has it, and he banks it off of the glass all the way down. Under 8 to go here in the Mustard and Crutchfield third period. Carolina looking for anything right now. Danger of coming to Biloxi and only scoring 2 here this week. And Batita almost gets held up at the blue line. Here's Kennedy. He winds up, centers one. Farmer not able to control it. Kennedy has it again, though. He waits. His shot gets deflected. Wyrick sprawling makes the save as Russell, he controls it. His clearing attempt's knocked down, though. Farmer plays a pass to himself. Sends it near side. Here's Joe Kennedy. All the space. A shot saved by Wyrick. Puck trickling around. Wyrick somehow has it. And he covers as now Helland and Kennedy are going to drop the gloves. Helland a couple of quick rights. Kennedy returns the favor. Helland and Kennedy going. Gloves go down. Helland goes down for a second. Kennedy getting some good licks. Kennedy holding him in. Helland returns with the right. Kennedy trying to get one. Kennedy sends him down. Joe Kennedy able to win another fight here this season. Gets six taps from the bench. After Justin Movalli did it 95 seconds into this period, Joe Kennedy trying to get one last push here from this Thunderbirds team. Been a while since we've seen Kennedy fight. You have to go all the way back to December 23rd, over a month ago. I remember he missed the first few weeks of 2024 out with a concussion, that time dropping the gloves and winning a decisive battle there against Lucas Helland. Carolina still has 16 seconds left on the power play. Trailing 4-1 with 7:18 remaining here in the third period. Attacking zone faceoff. It's one. Vanacek sends it out. A shot from Farmer. Save. Rebound. Pokes free on the near side. Vanacek with 9 to go here on the power play. Salak searching, trying to go cross ice. Vanacek, he has it. He waits his shot. And that one goes off of the handle of the stick of Wyrick and goes out of play here with 7:03 left to go in the third period. Carolina coming with a response here in this third period. Wyrick's been good though, and this one's cleared all the way down as Nielsen's out of the box. Karpinski gets rid of it quickly here with 6:52 to go here in the third period. Vanacek at his own half board, delivers one far side. Pastuco is Salak. Holds, brings it behind the cage. Pasuka gets tangled down, hand goes up. A delayed penalty coming up here against Mississippi as Carolina, just like that, is going to go back to the power play. It's going to be Sam Turner going off. Have Leah Rakos in the box as well. And Steve Harrison's going to use his timeout. Two minutes have been put up for both Leah Rakos. And for Turner. Carolina to the power play. They'll have 5-on-3. Here for the next 2 minutes of action. Steve Harrison calls the timeout. Don't forget, coming up on Tuesday, live from King's Crab Shack starting at 7 p.m. will be the newest edition of the Coach Harry Show. Live from King's Crab Shack starting at 7 p.m. Join myself and the head coach, Steve Harrison. So the special player guests coming up Tuesday from King's Crab Shack. Of course, you can catch it here on Thunderbirds TV and on WTOB. So 5-on-3, Carolina with an opportunity here. They call a hold against Turner. Leah Rakos. Sportsmanlike conduct, far side. Here's Salak, his pass deflected back out to the neutral zone. 17 seconds into this Little Italy power play, a 5-on-3 power play for the Thunderbirds. Vanacek, it's across the blue line, his pass deflected though. Clearing attempt, pokes free, here's Pastuca, top of the slot to Schnapp. Schnapp waiting, surveying, backhands it, here's Pastuca, back to Vanacek. He waits, sends it far side. Pass gets deflected into the corner, Salak has to whack at it. Dumas joining in the corner. Schnapp picks up the loose puck. Schnapp wraps it back out to Pastuca. 5:50 to go here in the third period, near side. Dumas in front, his shot goes wide past the far post. Vanacek tries to dump it in, takes a weird hop off of the stanchions. They whack Salaki holds. Out of Vanacek. He corrals a bouncing puck. Slides it far side. Salak back to Vanacek. Here's Pastuca near side. Walks in. His shot sails high. Goes high off of the glass. And comes all the way back out to the neutral zone with 45 seconds remaining here on the 5-on-3. Vanacek sends it behind the net. Dumas backhands it far side. Clay Keeley just came on. Back out to the point in Salak. Peter Vanacek, the long goal scorer. His pass deflected. Dumas goes down after he takes a hit from behind from Lynn. Clay Keeley, he corrals it, sends it to Vanacek. He waits back to Clay, a one-timer, and it's saved by Wyrick. And you got the left pad there. 10 seconds remain. Vanacek, a one-timer, and another save by Wyrick. 4 seconds left on the 5-on-3. Clearing attempt goes off of Schnapp. Clay Keeley picks it up. They're out of the box. Schnapp, a shot, save, rebound. That one goes off of the board. Salak almost able to make it a two-goal game. We got 4:27 to go here in the third period. Schnapp trying to kick it along. Too much on that touch. Liarakos clears the zone. Bouncing puck. Turner pokes it along. Liarakos, and an offside is called here at 4:17 to go in the third period. Carolina, the 5-on-3 opportunity, not able to find anything. And it's just been one of those weekends down here in Biloxi. 4:17 remains. Carolina trails 4-1. We're back to Biloxi after this. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
For over 85 years, Mustin and Crutchfield has been more than just a local market. We've been a proud part of North Carolina's heritage. When our founders started in 1938, they sourced meats from local farmers and groceries from small companies. Finding a way to stay competitive in this market has been a challenge through the years. Luckily, there are a lot of entrepreneurs, and now we have close to 50 local vendors that we feature. We're proud to partner with the Carolina Thunderbirds as a local sponsor, celebrating community values both on and off the ice. Mustin and Crutchfield, your hometown local grocer.
Back here in Biloxi, Carolina, they're trailing 4-1 with 4:17 remaining here in the third period. Brendan Riley with you here on Thunderbirds TV and on WTOP. It'll be a face-off across
from the Thunderbirds bench. After Mississippi just bit off a 5-on-3 opportunity.
One last chance here for the Thunderbirds to avoid being swept here this weekend by the Mississippi Seawolves. Puck trickles in behind the net. Bione trying to backhand it along. Instead, it's held up behind Cody Karpinski's cage. On the near side, Russell, he steps up. Or Liarakos backhands it in. Batita gloves it down. Carolina looks to break. John Batita all the way across the blue line, zips it over to Nate Keeley. His shot is blocked by Liarakos into the far corner. Zach Horn after the backhand pass from John Batita. Liarakos chases after Keeley into the corner with 3:45 left to go here in the third period. 4-1, your score here from Biloxi, Mississippi. It pops free. Nielsen, he can't get a good clean pass away. Batita. Sends it along. Horn picks it up, rattles it around. Carolina getting off for a change. 4-1 in favor of Mississippi. Carolina out shooting them 30-26. A one-timer in front. It goes wide from Keeley. Salak, he controls. Spins away from the defender. Searching for options. He can't find any. Salak sends it back out. Bione, a one-timer. It's blocked just a few feet away from him by Nielsen. And it's sent behind the cage. Turner, he'll hold there with 3 minutes left to go here in the third period. Carolina down to their last moments here in Biloxi. These two sides will see each other again on the 15th and 16th of February. A pass intercepted by Curtis Heggie. And it's dumped in. 2:35 left to go. Karpinski still in his net. Vanacek in the far corner. Chips it along near side. Pastuca has that at his skates, trying to throw it along. Back out, Salak. He loses it. It's taken away by Bond, who throws it into the skates of Heggie. Justin Barr, he couldn't hang on to it before Salak sends it far side. 2:15 left to go here in the third period. You have to wonder, even a three-goal game, if Karpinski comes out in the top of the slot. Here's a chance for Wong, throws it in front, and a shot goes wide. On the near side, it's picked up by Peter Manacic. Karpinski staying in his cage, and they're offside. .154 remains here in the third period. Face-off comes across from the Mississippi bench, and it's won by the Seawolves. Sent back out to the neutral zone. Bione chases after it all the way down, and that's icing. With 1:42 left to go in the third. So attack zone faceoff. Carolina out shooting Mississippi here tonight. Once again, 30-26 in our contact LLC. Shots on goal tracker, 11-2 here in this third. Blake Weirich, he has been the story of the weekend, though. Last night, saving 46-47. Tonight, he has saved 29-30. On the other side, Cody Karpinski saving 24-28. Last night, he saved 22-26 here this evening. Faceoff to the left of Weirich is won by Mississippi. Connor Lind throws it along. It's knocked down by Dumas. Backhands over Batita. Spins away from a man where the puck bounces free. At the near half boards, Lacio to Kuznetsov to the far side. Trying to dance his way in and going down in front of the net's Liorakos. Lacio banks a pass though, far side. Kuznetsov, he waits. Backhands it over to Liorakos with 80 seconds to go here in Biloxi. 4-1 in favor of Mississippi. Back in front, a shot from Liorakos is saved by Karpinski, and he covers here with 1:13 left to go here in the third period. Carolina back in action coming up next Friday. They welcome in the Danbury Hattricks to the Annex for the one and only series at home between the two sides. Those two sides, they started off the season up in Danbury back in the last weekend of October. Where you at, Section 6? 1:13 to go. Faceoff is won by Jan Salak with 70 seconds remaining here in the third period. Salak sends a man down into the corner.
1 minute
Bond kicks it along. Anderson getting on to it. Yuri Pastuka at the red line. 52 seconds remain here in Biloxi. Here's Solak to Pastuka. His shot is blocked. Rebound attempt in front. Weirich makes an initial save. Puck still bouncing around. Lind wanted Solak. Solak wanted no part of it. Heggie ships it along with 37 seconds left to go here in the third period. Seawolves fans making some noise. It's dumped in far corner by Heggie. Horn goes down to the ground with 23 seconds left to go. Mississippi looking for one last chance. Vaughn sent to the ground by Curtis Heggie. Shot goes through the crease. 10 seconds to go here in Biloxi, and Mississippi is going to hold it off. For the first time this season, the Carolina Thunderbirds have been swept here in 2023-2024. Your final score from the Mississippi Coast Coliseum, the Mississippi Seawolves 4 and the Carolina Thunderbirds 1. Carolina drops both games down here in Biloxi, and now they get set for Danbury coming up next weekend. Thunderbirds post game starts after this. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
I want Louie to live a long, happy life. I give him supplements to take care of his joints. He's on preventatives to keep the fleas and ticks away. It's the same with my Subaru Outback. It takes care of us every day and when we go on adventures. We get our Outback serviced by the experts at Flow Subaru of Winston-Salem. I love my Subaru and I know it will live a long and happy life if I treat it right, just like Huey.
Here at ComTech, we think it shouldn't cost a fortune to have peace of mind. That's why we bring you the latest in smart home protection and home monitoring at prices you can afford. Already paying for home monitoring? We can beat it.
Give us a call today or visit us at ctpower.com. That's ctpower.com. ComTech, your one stop for security, fire, cameras, and more.
Mabel Chase Golf and Country Club offers the best in recreational amenities in the Triad.
Come enjoy a meal at the Pine Brook Bar and Grill, relax by our pool and cabana, and gear up at the Pro Shop while sharpening your skills on our 9,000 square foot putting green, and play around on our 18-hole Ellis Maples Design Championship Golf Course. You can find out more at MapleChaseCC.com. That's MapleChaseCC.com.
Final score from Biloxi, Mississippi. Carolina falls to the Mississippi Seawolves by a score of 4-1. Carolina outshoots Mississippi 32-27. Goal in the first period from Jackson Bond, followed up by Peter Banachik, had his tied at one, going to the first intermission. In the second, Hugo Koch and Jackson Bond, 12 seconds apart, end up making it a 3-1 game, going to the third. Then 44 seconds into the third period, Joaquin Nielsen puts the final nail in the coffin on the Thunderbirds here this evening as Carolina falls by a final score of 4-1. Carolina, they drop here this season at 21-8-1. Mississippi drops or improves to 17-15-1. We wrap up Thunderbirds postgame after this. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
What's up, everybody? My name is Zach Taylor, and I'm the owner of Little Donuts. We're a mini donut food truck company specializing in apple cider mini donuts, traveling all over, setting up at different events. This year, I'm happy to announce that we are a proud partner of the Carolina Thunderbirds. And we're going to be set up inside the Annex building all season long at every home game. So while you're out supporting your favorite hockey team, swing by and warm up with some hot, fresh apple cider mini donuts made on site right when you order. Thank you. Hope you have a great day. And go Birds.
My name is Melissa Pilsen, and I'm with Brianna Phillips. We're the proud owners of the Pet Barn. We've been in business for over 22 years.
We offer boarding, grooming, and daycare. You can find us at 7844 Blues Creek Road. Message us on Messenger, Facebook, or contact us 336-451-7508.
We are also proud sponsors of the Thunderbirds.
What's the word?
Thunderbirds!
Back here on Thunderbirds postgame, getting ready to wrap this one up. Carolina falls tonight by a final score of 4-1 here against the Mississippi Seawolves. They get swept here this weekend. Your third starts, Blake Weirich with 31 saves on 32 shots. Hugo Koch, she gets 2 points, a goal and assist for the second star, and Jackson Bond is named your first star with 2 goals on the evening. Carolina, they swept for the first time here this season. Now they look to rebound coming up next Friday at 7:35 p.m. against the Danbury Hatricks in the rematch of the Commissioner Cup final from a season ago. And don't forget, on Tuesday at 7 p.m. live from King's Crab Shack, newest edition of the Coach Harry's Show coming up at 7 p.m. here on Thunderbirds TV and on WTOB. Carolina falls here tonight. They're swept. 5-1 loss last night, 4-1 loss here this evening. Now it's back to the drawing board with Danbury coming to town next weekend. That'll do it for us here from Biloxi. For my producer back in the WTOB studios, Rick O'Neill, the radio guy, I'm Brendan Riley saying